when he first moved in to, or at least when my dad moved into his new house, it was actually my grandmother's old house, and she left her life alert. And so the first thing my sister does in the new fucking house, goes and she finds the life alert. She thinks, like, it's a little symbol thing, like, that, like, flashes a light in the wall, and boom, it's like a symbol. And she presses it, and it fucking goes off. And it's like, shit, motherfucker, no.
Good job.
No.
The worst, like, I'd had, the worst thing I've done in this, like, similar fashion is at once at an airport, I was so bored, I fucking, you know, like, they have payphones. I'm like, oh, you can't really call anybody because you need to put money in. I don't have money. I also have no one to call. I wonder if 911 still works.
God.
Still works.
Oh, damn it. Like, what'd you say when you got on the phone?
I heard someone talk, went, and hung up really quickly and ran.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God.
Were police sent to the fucking airport?
I got in my airplane at that point and was like, I don't fucking know.
Uh-huh.
I mean, it was a payphone. It probably, you can't tell where that's from.
Tell where it's from, but yeah. it's like a hot, but like, they don't have, the fucking police don't have time to go after every errant fucking phone call. Like, yeah. Officer, I need you to go to the fucking airport. I got a call, and they just went, and I believe there might be a situation there. So I'm gonna need you to go to the airport and track down whatever fucker did it, even though it's fucking, even though turnover in the airport is granted fairly slow, but still.
Like, what age were you at when this happened?
I was really young. I must have been, like, it scared the shit out of me, so I must have been really young. Probably about 7 or 8.
Okay, they probably thought, like, there was this high-pitched, and they're like, well, it was just a fucking kid.
Yeah, I had a fucking girl's voice when I was young.
You still do.
Yeah. A really fucking, like, ugly Russian girl or something. Maybe not Russian. What's a very stereotypical... Tibetan? I don't know.
Tibetan? I don't know. Anyway, we're doing D&D, yeah.
Yeah, here in Echo? Sorry if you're from Tibet. You're a lovely people.
We're doing D&D. Dungeons & Dragons. Oh. Yeah. So, last time on D&D...
Why does it still say inventories and shit when there's nothing here?
Well, you have nothing in your inventories, so...
I have shit!
I have several swords. Remember, I have several swords on me at the moment.
This sounds like a bullshit excuse, Nick.
I have.
There's nothing.
I have
in your inventory.
A hammer.
You do have.
I have a hammer.
You do have a hammer.
I have a hammer.
That's
I have
on your character. Swords. And Ian has a sword, which is also shown on his character.
I have more than one sword.
Well, that
I have the determination of 1,000 suns. I feel like that would classify as an item.
I'm gonna call bullshit on that.
Listen, anything goes. Like that hit song from the 50s.
What?
I have no idea if it was from the 50s.
Are you talking about Here It Goes, Here It Goes, Here It Goes Again?
Not here.
Oh, here
no.
It goes. Oh,
no.
Oh, here it goes.
Anything goes.
Oh, here it goes again. Anyway, last
it's
time.
If you play Fallout for more than like fucking 10 minutes, you'll hear it.
Alright. Wait, which one? 1, 2, 3, or 4?
Any of them? Probably 4. I think it's in 3 as well. They bring back a lot of the same music, because it's pretty good music.
Alright, well, anyway. Our last time on Dungeons & Dragons, I think.
Hey, you leave Stoke fucking... Not Stoke, Steve Austin. Gnarl Bearson alone, motherfucker.
Who the... What? I'm not moving him.
I know you're not moving him, but someone's putting red eyes on him.
Oh...
This bear is a stone-cold motherfucker. There is no glint of anything going on in his fucking eyes. You can't tell. He strikes without warning.
Just a little...
More specifically, like he just comes up behind you, then all you hear is a little pop, and then your neck is turned 180 degrees.
I mean, it's only like half a circle. No big deal.
So... Okay, great.
So last time...
We're all there... This is the best party. We're all varying degrees of fucking useless.
We have bear who's completely useless.
Billy,
no,
we're really
not there.
I mean, really, all of you guys have killed at least one person, so Good job. Chris.
No.
He sat there and watched.
So wait,
I've killed no one.
I take that to mean Dawn is dead.
No.
You can take that to mean whatever you like.
Nobody's died from Harmony.
Mm-hmm.
But no, we're all varying degrees of useless.
We got
our knight, who's supposed to be a tank with very, very low stats that aren't gonna help. We got a fucking bear with it who has zero care for actually being part of the party. And then we got a pacifist. This is gonna end super well. And we're gonna fucking help a rebellion? Yay!
So it's basically fucking, what can Ian do? Because he's the only one that's actually doing anything.
Yeah, I'm the only one who actually does anything.
Then the
Stop turning the bear.
Stop fucking...
Surrender!
You're a piece of shit.
Anyway,
all right.
Here's what happened. All right,
fuck you.
You guys got whatever into this, and you woke up in this jail cell, and you were all icky and didn't have very much body movements. Then you ate stuff, and black mist dissipated from your body, and then you were fine to walk around. Then Don came around and was like, "Hey, I'm taking you to Paul," and you're like, "Sure." Well, besides Ian, he was like, "No."
Wait.
And Don took you guys to Paul, and he was like, "Hey,
wait.
I'm King Guy."
Wait.
And Paul and Don took you guys back into the jail cell, and then Gonzo showed up as well as Nina, and they were like, "Hey, how's it going? Want to join the rebellion?" And you're like, "Sure, I'll join the rebellion." And then they're like, "Cool. Join the rebellion." And Iggy was a piece of shit.
That's not what happened.
And Iggy
first,
was a piece of shit.
That was like, "Hey, we're gonna fucking think about it." Then I left, and then was like, everyone's like, "Okay, this is the thing to do now." And then I took back my decision. Everyone just fucking continued going on.
I mean, yeah. And after they got out, they got to a bridge and was like, "Beep beep, oh no, there's headlights and whatever, spotlights and whatever." And then you jumped into the river. And then somehow you got back to the same point you were at when you jumped into the river, but this time there was no, like, lights or spotlights or anything, and you're like, "Alright, sure, let's get out of the river." And then there were guys there, and you killed the guys.
And Bug says that river never comes back.
We didn't kill him. We killed one guy. The other dude's fucked up so hard, they decided to give the fuck up. So we took one. Then we knocked both of them out, took one back to their leader, and then the bear went back, killed John, came back, tried to kill more people, and is now currently following a guard to who the fuck knows where.
Correct.
And also, then Harmony and Sir Arm are fucking around in the base. I don't know what the fuck Sir Arm's doing. Maybe I guess he's fucking around with the Smith. Mm-hmm. And Harmony's sitting on a couch with Nina. Great.
Yeah.
And then the dude came and he was like, "Hey, I'm gonna talk about how we have new members, I guess, even though, you know, there was like zero induction ceremony."
I mean, the induction, what is that?
The plane.
A plane?
What?
Do you see its wings?
I mean, I see the wings, but why are you drawing a plane?
Why is anyone doing anything, man? It's a question of life.
This is happening right now.
It is. And I'm confused.
You just sit
why.
There and wonder, like, look up and you're saying, like, what is my purpose in life?
Who do we start with? Do we start with the fucking bear or the actual...
We're gonna start with the bear, yes.
Can you start by getting rid of Ian's ability to do fucking anything and then kick him?
Oh, if only. Anyway, bear time. Yeah.
I mean, the easiest way to do that is to have somebody kill his character.
No, I mean, like, his ability to draw. He's being a piece of shit.
I really don't know if I can, actually.
I think my, like, positioning broke or whatever.
Cool. That's not the only thing that's gonna fucking break in a second.
Man, you're gonna break your headphones again? postpone it.
Yeah, my headphone's broken. I got a nice repair now.
But now you gotta lay on your bed or something, or something.
What?
To talk into it.
I did have a problem where I needed an AV splitter, but I got the AV splitter today through the mail.
Cool.
So it's currently working out pretty damn well.
Coolio, my bro. Up to the hizzy, my dizzy. We're gonna start with you.
Fucking stop your shit.
Hey, Nick just went live. D&D, I think, week one.
Avoid what the fuck?
D&D, I think, week one.
No, it says
week one.
It says week two, Chris. One. It says
I have
week two.
I have an email. That says fuck you now.
It says week two.
Can confirm it says week one.
It says week two.
Week one.
I mean, I'm gonna go to twitch.television slash
Super Mr. Ninja. Do you want me to forward you the email?
I mean, if I go to twitch.television slash Super Mr. Ninja, it says D&D, I think, week two. Oh boy.
Nah, forward him the
email. Would you look at that? Week two.
I would forward him the email, but I never actually got his email address. I really don't want it.
Fuck.
It's probably not that hard to find. Honestly, you could probably go on college.
I'm the fucking failure. 69@gmail.com.
How did you know?
Every time Nick tries to do anything.
Seriously, how did you know?
Fucking
acronym.
Anyway, when last we left off, you were chasing this guy.
This was not this
most
was already
riveting.
Firstly, the dude's already gone, and I was chasing after him.
Yeah.
Yep, that is true.
But we're gonna start from this point in time.
Great, he left. I'm following him.
Yeah.
Done.
Alright, we're gonna start here, alright? This is the easiest place to start. Alright, so.
No, it isn't!
Yeah, it is!
No, it isn't.
It is, though!
Why?
Thank you.
I mean, where else would I start?
You have no content. You could actually start with the actual plot, but nah, we'll just go on the fucking side tangent where the bear murders people.
Hey, you're the side tangent. How about that?
Ooh. Ian, stop!
I think it was a fucking bear.
There's gotta be a way. You could probably also ban him.
There's gotta be a way. I can't believe neither of you figured out how to stop it yet, other than clearing the damn board every 5 seconds.
Hang on, I'm looking it up.
Jesus, did you just play a bunch of fucking static? What the hell is that?
I was about to say the same thing.
It's nice music, right?
No, it's horrible.
Deep breath, deep breath. Is someone going into labor? The name of the song.
Versus Master of Shadow.
This is, like, battle music. Look at all the shit I'm battling, everyone!
I mean, you're technically battling the one guy. He's running away, you're running after him.
He doesn't know it.
Let's see.
How did you even draw it that fast? Are you, like, drawing it off screen?
No.
Well, there is no way to actually block somebody from drawing.
Wow. Okay.
So,
that's
either Ian needs to grow up, or I need to threaten to kick him.
Hey, isn't this the same icon from fucking Minecraft?
Wow.
Yeah, it is.
Weird.
In any case, it's currently...
Oh, this is one too.
It's currently nighttime. You just finished crossing back over the bridge, following after the guard that you were so desperately chasing after to try and, in quotes, snap his neck, like a stone cold motherfucker.
Yep.
So, how long?
This character went from varying degrees to worst.
Okay, Nick, can you please just change the music? This is awful.
You can turn the music off, you know.
Yeah, that's what I've done.
I
don't need to listen to this shit. I don't need to listen to whatever the fuck any DM has to put up with.
I was going
to
say, you have like a persona fetish, but never mind.
Persona's good.
He does. He does.
I mean,
jolly good music on the way to snap someone's neck.
We're keeping this. So
you see my character trying to get him on two legs and start prancing forward, snapping necks as he goes.
So how long are you going to follow this guy before you give up or try to do something else? I need time
until I find
him. That's all. That's his sole deter goal in this
that's
current.
All
life
you
right want now,
to do is snap his neck.
Yep.
He will follow him to the end of the earth.
So
he goes to Antarctica and becomes a penguin. I'm gonna follow him.
All right. So he's running at this point quite fast, actually. So I need you to roll a check of some sort. This is going to be a dex check. So a d20 plus a 17. Get like a, I don't know, 18?
Yeah. Here we go. What? I could have literally failed and still passed the roll?
Look, I was just like oh yeah, get this number. I kind of forgot, like, oh yeah, 17 plus 1 equals 18.
Yeah, great. Good job.
And you barely got it anyway.
You fail and still manage to pass.
Back at the rolls I made. They're all fucking red.
They actually are. Oh, that's great. That's great. So, you're trying to run after him as fast as you can, but you're really not able to get any ground. Like, you're able to keep pace with him, but at the same time, you're just, like, inching closer to him. And after about a solid 30 minutes of running, like, he's running, like, full sprint, and so are you. He eventually stops by a tree and is, like, panting super fucking hard.
There goes his neck.
You can visibly see the sweat dripping down off of him and hitting the ground. And this is also at nighttime, so that just like makes it even like more. Holy shit, this guy is super sweating. He stops, and then you catch up to him, and you're like right behind him. So at this point, he looks back behind him, and he sees you, and he's like, "Hey, bear, how's it?"
Why the fuck is everyone in this world just fucking accustomed to bears? Are bears like fucking dogs?
Who knows?
Who knows?
It's like that fucking bear from Avatar.
It could be loopy.
No, that bear was actually fucking rare.
Are you talking about Momo, Appa? Which one?
The literal bear. Just the bear.
Oh, from Earth City.
The Platypus bear?
Yeah.
No, the bear. Oh. Just bear.
I don't know anything about
Spirit
Avatar.
Spirit bear? No.
There was,
I have no idea what you're talking
about. Say, the king had a bear. It was just a bear, and that's what was weird about it.
That's the Earth bear.
It wasn't like a weird hybrid.
Yeah, that's the Earth City bear.
Bossing Say.
Yeah.
All right, moving along. I mean, he's probably tired as hell and he doesn't give a fuck anymore. He stopped caring about anything. He's just like, look, it's a bear. Hey, bear, fucking up. Oh, you killed me. That's okay. I was tired anyway.
So that's probably what Nick's gonna do.
So he turns to you and says, There's some squirrels back there about like 5 minutes if you want to go get them. I'm just gonna rest here for like 10 more seconds. I'm gonna go. At this point,
we started with this.
What?
We started with this story.
At this point,
starting with this story.
What do you want to do? I guess.
We've already lost all the people from last week.
Well, since he's paying so much attention to me, I guess. Fucking trot up next to him and see what happens there.
Alright, he starts to pet you.
Now fucking seduce him.
Now, this guy's pets are nowhere near as good as Don's. Like, Don's was just, like, super amazing. Like, oh my god. This guy's...
Yeah,
just,
I don't...
Wasn't his
I
name...
Don't hear about
wasn't his name John? Wasn't his name John?
It what? Was Don! Right?
It was John, but you said Don and it that was... became the running joke.
Right.
Yeah, that was the thing.
Hey, get it? Because the guy was running? That's the joke? Eh? Eh?
Nope.
Oh.
I have no idea what you're talking about. Because
the guy right now is running.
What?
I don't think anyone understands your logic.
You're giving us an explanation, but I don't know what the punchline was.
It's really, really bad.
I found that was an amazing joke. I don't know what you're talking about.
What's the punchline? You're giving an explanation with no punchline.
Like, the guy that you were just chasing after was running, right? And
cool.
That was the running joke.
Oh, you're just shit.
Yeah, it's not particularly great. You're honestly better off not knowing.
A bit late.
Anyway, he starts petting you. Did you just, like, stare still?
Well, how about this? Take out a fucking front pawn, point forward.
Alright, so you point forward, and you're currently in the, like, the middle of a forest, so he's like, oh yeah, there are trees. Do you see... He looks to you and says, do you see a squirrel over there? And then he looks, like, where you're pointing.
And this is the part where you fucking snap next.
Uh-huh, D20 plus 17.
Same roll.
I mean,
that's
holy
shit! Oh god, he did!
God. What the fuck?
He's dead.
Why are you just so attuned at snapping necks?
What do you mean so attuned? The first time I attempted it, I failed, and the second time I attempted it, failed.
I know, but
I just kept doing it until you gave it to me.
I know, but to snap somebody's neck, you still need like a 17, at least. Holy shit!
Yeah.
All right, so.
Am I gonna get like
he needs a 7? Wait, he needs a 17 at
like,
least. So he can still critically
like
fail
natural,
this and still do it?
Natural 17, Chris. Natural.
Even I understood that.
Fuck you, I don't give a fuck.
Any case.
I'm gonna snap your neck next.
He's looking off into the distance. You know, trying to find the little squirrel that this
Ian,
nice...
How you lose your character week 2. I'm just saying it. Characters.
Man, I mean... Not entirely opposed to that plan.
It immediately stopped, okay.
So, you're looking off... So, this guy is looking off into the distance, still pretty panting. Panting quite heavily. And he's like, oh, is there like a little squirrel over there? And he like... Visibly, like, his head moves forward about 10 inches, at which point you just stand up on your hind legs, put one hand on his chin, the other on the side of his head, and then...
Let it rip.
He is dead.
Beyblade, let it rip.
Just straight up dead. You see his
Stop
lifeless corpse on the ground, and his, like, one of his eyes hasn't actually closed, so... One of his eyes is open while the other is closed, and it looks really, like, kind of disgusting, to be honest. But since you're a stone-cold motherfucker, you don't give two shits about him.
Don't answer.
Chat,
okay.
Find a picture. Find us a picture, if you exist. Probably don't exist.
Mega's find there. Yeah.
Oh, great.
Mega.
Fucking
Mega,
you, Snapping hey, Chronicles.
We play card games with Mega, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
He Mega, plays please, fishes.
Be a good guy. Good guy. Find us a picture. We're all busy.
Of what?
Of a guy with his neck snapped and one eye open.
I'm pretty sure if you go to fucking 4chan, you'll find a bunch of that.
It's
or
so easy to find, right?
I mean, if you can find ISIS paintings, I'm pretty sure you can find his neck snapped. I'm pretty sure if you can find whatever Chris found for that fucking... What was that, like, you fucking... That thing you found on Reddit, which is, like, the fucking disgusting stories?
Oh, dude, those are those great.
The fucking cum.
Yeah.
They're all
great. You can find that. I'm pretty sure you can find that snap neck somewhere.
Cum sock kill.
Anyway,
do you want to do anything with his body?
I'm gonna fucking try this system out.
Eat
and
it.
I'm gonna loot it.
Eat it.
All right.
Eat it.
What happens?
Damn.
You just straight up loot him. On his person. On his
had
person.
A lot of cops.
On his person, you find about 30 gold, a sword, and what seems to be a healing potion. Two of them.
Ooh,
wow. So does he have opposable thumbs?
I know.
No.
Bears
okay,
do not
no.
have thumbs. Historically, no.
Yeah. Yeah, but this is fucking D&D. Anything can fucking go as long as the DM says okay.
Doesn't a bear have thumbs?
Well, considering you're so dexterous, it's like you have thumbs.
Great.
That's
so he doesn't.
That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it.
Sure.
So, you're just... doesn't have it, and if we close the door, he should have to break down said door.
I mean... maybe?
Headbutts, or I could snap the door's neck.
That is
sure.
One plausible
thing. Snap the door's neck. If you could even find the door's neck.
So, what do you want to do now?
Eat him.
Head back towards the right.
Damn.
Right. My work here is done.
You could eat him, you know.
You successfully make it back to the bridge without anyone noticing, or anyone, like, seeing you, or you seeing anyone else. Nothing happens on your way back to the bridge.
Okay.
Wow, that was disappointing.
You do see one squirrel, though.
That's leave it alone. It.
Yeah.
However, there's those motherfuckers over there.
Huh? Nope, there's...
No, those guys are dead.
Yeah, no.
Those
are the dead bodies.
One of those is dead. One of those is dead. One of those is knocked out. Nope, one is knocked out.
Is
unless,
the knocked out
you know,
person still there?
Yeah. Then Pep fucking Nina killed him while Harmony wasn't looking. But
I'm pretty sure they're both dead.
No, this one All right. is knocked out. This one is dead.
Fine. Since I wouldn't know that, take a pulse.
Alright.
No, we killed two of them, and then we took one that was knocked out with us.
We killed one, and knocked out two.
Like, Nina was about to kill the other one, like, she got close, but ended up just knocking him out. Anyway, you take a pulse, you find out, oh hey, this guy's still alive. This one.
Snap his neck.
You easily snap his neck. He's unconscious, he can't do anything about it.
Loot him and leave, I guess.
Alright. This guy doesn't have anything on him. Like, he
Got
used
it.
To have a sword. God damn.
Take his pants.
Alright, you take it. Do you put them on?
Yes.
Alright. You now have the guard's pants.
That's it.
Now
continue forward.
These pants are pure purple. And by purple, I mean like deep purple. Like
it's a regal color.
Mm-hmm. Like, it's almost black purple, but it's not. It's, like, extremely dark purple. And so
Man,
you're
just a reveal.
Just this giant...
We're just a ravioli coming to this.
Dark purple fans. So, what direction do you want to go?
Right.
You go.
Go the other way to go. I'm still following the scent of the fuckers.
All right.
Yeah.
You follow...
Man, is that...
And I assume it's their turn. Should go to them.
Yeah, I know. Quick update on the state of everything. Where is that thing? My jig. Hang on. There it
no,
is.
No, we just stood there and waited for the bear to show up.
Yep.
And then suddenly the bear showed up and the plot progressed. Actually.
So currently, these guys are there.
Is this actually just like a straight up beach ship?
Yeah.
It's just a fucking overworld.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the overworld state.
This is a shitty overworld.
What happened was you found a fucking map, you blacked everything out, and then you made the story around it.
Oh, no. I found the base map, but all the buildings and such are actually added by me.
Ah. You did half the work.
All the buildings and stuff.
And you're like back there.
All currently two structures are all built by him. Everything else will be plot convenient.
There's like 12.
Everything else will be convenient.
There's like
no, they weren't built by him. They were fucking taken from the asset library and put there by him.
I mean, there's like 14 buildings. There's a good amount, anyway.
Oh, spoiler alert.
Like, you're gonna guess what the 14 buildings are gonna be.
One of them's a whorehouse.
Another's an actual town, and another's a town, and another's a town. There's got to be a couple towns.
Any case, you being
Look at
Harmony
that text, though.
And Sir
the
Arms.
Fuck did that come from? Look at that.
Remember that?
Oh, right. I remember time. That text.
Yep.
Yeah, that was a thing.
Mm-hmm. Ron Shlom Shaktiku?
All right.
Yeah.
Jason, Nina. Alright, so he was just talking to us about the new members. Then he started yelling at Jason.
Right.
Then I yelled.
So, you guys got down here and were like, oh, hey, there's a couch. Ian was like, oh, hey, there's swords over here. And then Ron Shalom Shak Tikku, or as everyone likes to call him, Ron, got up on the stand and was like, hello, new people that are going to join us. We are Claw. And then Jason fucked up at some point and wrote Clack instead of Claw. And Ron yelled at Jason for a solid, like, 3 minutes. At which point, he then turns to you guys and is like, so, hi, I'm Ron. That's Jason the fuck up. You've already been acquainted with Nina, and Gonzo's back there as well as our leader and such. And when he says back there, he points back to here where the curtains are.
Or is, not just back there. Is there any more members?
There is... Carrie is back there with him. But other than that... Okay. Well...
I have a secondary branch.
Well,
for... An Indian tech squad?
For the most part, this is all of us, but we do have some, like, people working with us, like, out in the world. So,
Okay.
What can you guys do?
I heal for the most part and do magic tricks.
Ah.
Yeah.
Now you see me, now you don't.
I can fight with any melee weapon.
Most people can do that, right?
Just yeah.
Pick up a thing and attack with the thing, right?
Most people can do that. Most people can pick up things and attack with things.
But skillfully?
Yeah, any skill you had is negated by the fact that your stats are pretty shit, so...
Pretty much.
Let's move on.
You're also likely to die because you're Ian.
I'm going to hurt you.
That is just... I mean...
Before you die!
To be entirely... The only character you're in danger of dying from is Dominic's character.
It's not so much a likelihood as it is an inevitability. Like, all roads lead to death.
It's not in the game!
I have NPCs, which you've already killed some, so sure, good job.
Yeah, alright, so, hey, Ron, do you have any, like, medical supplies around here?
Yeah, we got some in the back, and he nods this way.
Okay, could you get some?
I mean...
Could you get some? There were some injuries sustained in a previous fight.
Were there?
Nina.
Did she?
Yeah. I'm fairly sure Nina got hit.
Oh yeah, she took two.
I don't think anybody else got anything out.
She got hit.
Yeah, so like if you could like bring some bandages or some, or if you could like bring some of your medical supplies, that would be 100% great.
Yep, looks like Nina doesn't want any, so nah. And
no, that's
Nina,
fine.
Yeah, Nina shakes her head like no, I don't want any.
No, okay.
So, what are you two guys' names?
I am Sir Arm.
Please don't ask him for his backstory.
All right, and you, Miss?
I'm Harmony.
All right, welcome to Claw.
We had a solid 15 minutes of that last time.
Jason, you're still a fuck up. So our main mission goal, whatever you want to call it, take down corrupt King Paul. We have many avenues working on doing that. We're trying to work in from the political side. We're trying to work in from the fighting side. We're going for a scatter position until like one of them, you know, works out, and we're just gonna go get him. You know, simple.
That's so not a very sound tactic.
You're sniping with a shotgun, essentially.
If you want to.
Yeah, that sounds good and all, given all the information I have about the king. But there's only, from what I counted, about actual names you've given us, 6 people here.
Everybody in our group consists of Nina, me, no, also known as Ron, Jason, Gonzo, Carrie, and Moto. He is our leader.
Okay.
We do have, like, informants, but they're not formally a part of Claw.
When do we get to meet the leader guy?
I'd say when he wants to meet you. Oh, he usually doesn't come out from behind those curtains back there. It's kind of his thing. We don't really, you know.
Pay no attention to the man behind the curtains.
We don't.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we don't. Okay. We don't really like mess with him back there. It's his place, you know.
Okay, so he's just secretive. Okay.
That's why you don't want to know.
It's a
bastardization of everything.
Oh, look, it's Gonzo. Okay, alrighty. What, do you know what happened to have the time? Nobody's been able to tell me the time.
You know, it's like 5 in the morning now.
Great. 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 That's okay.
So, Gonzo comes in from the curtain, and he's like, yo. I see you met Harmony and Sarah.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. They seem decent, I guess. Did they fight at all while you guys were out? They did pretty well. Well, Harmony was just kind of standing there, but Arm, he did something. Yeah. Oh, they're pretty cool. And Ron's like, sure. Alright, so, Gonzo, you know what we're gonna do tomorrow? Or today, actually. Damn. Should probably go to sleep, to be honest. Arm, Harmony, you guys tired? I'm assuming you are.
Yeah.
Has tiredness ever actually been a thing? Has anyone ever actually had physical fatigue?
There is not in any of our games, but there is the potential that if you're up for like 24 hours or like 18 hours, or depending on the amount of physical strenuousness and other such things, it can happen.
The space game.
Yeah, I was about to say, remember those 5 weeks you were awake and battling?
Yeah, I know, it was crazy. Anyway, Gonzo, like,
Remember how you made the ship completely dumb as hell?
Okay, so, alright, we're gonna go to bed soon. Fuck it. Might as well waste everything I got. Might as well waste everything. Let's go ahead and just heal Nina.
Alright.
There you go.
So you try to your hand on her, and she kind of, like, jumps back a little, but then...
No, it's okay. No, it's okay. Calm down. It's okay. I don't hurt you.
She's fine. She nods her head, and then lets you heal her for 1. Good job. So, Chris,
okay.
I'm going to need you to send me your spells for the next day.
Oh, wait. I have 1 more thing I want to do.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Nina, I'm going to do something. I need you to point at 1 person, and it will happen to them.
She points to Arm.
Aren't you supposed to be the nice character?
Okay.
I wouldn't worry.
Okay, and then I use my create water, and I do it above him, and there we go.
Do I make a reaction?
Yeah, you react.
It's water! The fuck are you...
He's the chick
doesn't
from
do much.
What do I roll to dodge?
Water.
I mean, you don't dodge. You can make a saving throw versus it, but you don't like just straight up dodge it.
It's H2O, not H2No.
D20 plus 6 is your roll, by the way.
Can't possibly kill you.
You need like 17. Hey, you got it.
Triple crit,
19 damage.
So it doesn't deal any damage to you, but you're still, like, quite wet.
Hey!
Har, har, har.
Magic!
Hami, you're cleaning that up. And he walks over to you, gives you...
What?
He walks back here, comes out with a rag and gives it to you. You know, like, clean up
Isn't
the water.
Isn't it, like, a dirt floor?
It's water. It's water. It'll evaporate. Don't you worry.
We're down in a cellar.
That's not my problem.
It is now. He hands you the rag and walks back. You don't get to sleep?
Okay, then I'm gonna call you out on this then. Why the fuck is there a forge in a cellar? How is that venting?
Oh, there's a chimney.
And don't forget, it's pitch black outside, so you can't see the smoke.
That's not how that works.
Anyway, he gives you the rag, and he's like, walks off.
Plus, we're in an airship. We're in an airship wreck.
You're in a boat wreck. This is a boat.
You said airship. You said airship.
I never said airship. No. I may have said a ship.
You said land ship.
You said airship. Go back to the last session. You said airship.
You can go back for me. Sure. I'm not. I didn't say airship.
I will actually bet you $10. I have the money. He said land ship. Granted, you have no way to answer that. So.
Right. It was land ship, not airship. What was I thinking?
So wait, is this like actually? So wait. So Nick, what is this ship actually?
This ship was a boat.
Still
is a boat. Actually, but, it's
beached?
Kind of.
Is it beached or is it like?
As far
or is
as
it like fucking.
As far as you know, it is beached.
It's a land ship. I asked if it could still work, and you said, and you're. I think Gonzo said, no, it doesn't work.
Yes, because there are many holes in it, stopping it from floating
on
water. Kind of
fucking crashed.
I said air, land, whatever. Goddamn,
anyway.
The thing from last game.
Moving on to the next day.
Yeah, Gonzo takes you and Sir Arm back into his humble abode. And this is the point where we go back.
Good.
To Iggy.
Where am I, actually?
Fucking you're
riveting.
Trying to follow the scent still, actually. So I should have you here.
I'm back at the bridge, apparently.
Yeah, no. You made your way down river quite a bit. And I'm going to need you to roll to see if you can continue following the scent. Or if it's just, like...
What is this, a perception check? Or
at this point. It would be...
It is a perception. Thing.
Yeah, it'd be perception. So D20 plus 16. You're gonna need like a 27.
Why is the up command not working?
I mean 16, not 17. You need D20 plus 16, not
17. Hey.
What the fuck? Alright, yeah. You perfectly pick up the scent and are able to perfectly find where exactly they are at. Good job. So you walk.
Growl or some shit.
So at this point, it takes you about another three or four hours to actually get to the house.
Went back and snapped a neck. It didn't take 4 hours.
No,
Jesus.
I mean like travel time. Like you, like it. Like it took them like 3 or 4 hours to actually get to the boat. So it's gonna take.
How the fuck did it take me so long to get? Like they fucking left out a tunnel. I went back through the tunnel, snapped the neck.
You're only like half an hour behind them, is what I'm trying to say.
Oh, this is like.
Wait, what? He's only half an hour behind us.
Like, about half an hour, yeah.
Are you saying, like, the events are happening simultaneously?
Yeah.
Okay.
So he went. So, in the time it took him to go back, snap John's neck, and chase that guy to an indeterminate location, he's somehow only 30 minutes behind.
I think it was like, it should be like a little bit longer, wasn't it like...
Okay, you're like an hour behind. That seems a bit
Takes
fair.
A little bit more sense.
That's slightly more reasonable, yeah.
Alright, so...
30 minutes behind.
Like it fucking matters.
You find
Nick.
This place, and you can still tell that the scent is coming from like... Around here, but you can't pinpoint where exactly. Yes, Ian?
Ian.
3 hours, 44 minutes, 40 seconds, you say it's a ground ship. And then I say, so it's a land ship.
Get off
and
his dick about
the
ship.
So it's a land ship.
What? You just ground land, what's the fucking difference?
What's the time again?
What does
Three
it
hours. 44 minutes, 40 seconds.
It's a D&D railed stream. Yeah.
Holy shit. It's happening.
Alright.
Well. Hey.
So you make it to this abandoned boat. It looks like it's been wrecked quite handily.
I probably said that to Nick.
Okay, question, so is it a ship or an airship? So see,
it is
that
a
was right.
ground ship.
Wow. All right. Wow. Wow.
I should have said grounded ship instead of ground ship.
I'm sorry.
Ship.
You said airship, motherfucker.
I'm not the one who said airship. He's the one who said airship.
I know, I'm talking to Ian.
Yeah. But I
How
should
are
have
you technically right in any of this?
I should have said grounded ship instead of ground ship, even though it's still technically a ground ship. Whatever.
But then anyway. you confirmed it was a land ship.
Oh my god.
Iggy, you're gonna need to roll another perception check to see if you can actually find a way to get inside there.
Significant. Okay, there's no in between. It's 19 or 18.
All right. So
no, wait. I think it must have been 19 and 2 this game. Well, like this session, I think. Oh no, wait, I did roll a 3.
So
but it's mainly 19 and 2. What are the odds?
So you can still smell that they're around here somewhere, but you can't, for the life of you, find where exactly it is they are. It's like they're in an alternate dimension, but they're standing right next to you in the alternate dimension. You can smell them. It's like you're right on top of them. You just like
I'm going to sleep standing up.
All right. Do you lie and sleep in like a corner or something or what?
Nope, in the middle of the room, just standing up, sleep.
All right. And you sleep.
Bears actually don't sleep standing up.
Well, now they do.
I'm not sure anything actually does sleep standing up. Maybe it's
actually,
a
nope, there are things.
Horses
there
and
are,
cows do.
There not are always.
A variety of animals.
Not always.
Not always, but they do occasionally.
They so lock not... their knee joint in order to do it.
The more you know.
Yay. So everybody now is tired, so you're
sure
all like...
I'm fairly sure if you got a human being tired enough, they could sleep standing up.
People pass out.
Yeah.
They could sleep against a wall that's supporting them, but they can't, like, stay standing up unconscious.
Locking knees and whatnot.
They can. It's not likely.
Anyway, everybody's tired at this point. Everyone's like, yeah, I don't want to be awake anymore. So everybody goes to sleep. Everybody takes a little nap. Everybody goes to bed. Betty, bye.
Really
Chris, need your spells. God, why is that the only thing that happens? Chris, spells, go. Hurry up.
Fuck. Hold on.
Hit me up with them spells, dog.
I need to look at...
Oh,
okay.
I'll send you the spells. Wait, no, you should...
No, I have it.
Yeah, you should still have it.
I have, but I'm just looking through them, and... okay. Okay, alright, here we go. Wrong person.
Anyway, everybody takes a little Betty Bye. In your rooms? Alright. So, in your...
Oh, we all have personal rooms?
Well, no.
Fuck.
By rooms, I'm talking like, oh yeah, Iggy's there, and then, like, Ian's there. Ian's also there.
Ian's...
Never mind.
Keep trailing off. Nothing
Whatever.
Happened. We don't have any information.
Yeah, no, y'all go to Betty by nice and quiet. You wake up, and you just, like, walk around. You find that the rooms that you stayed in were pretty, like, decent. Like, it seems like the insides of the ship were well-preserved to where there are plenty of places to sleep that are still, like, intact and... quite comfortable, actually. Like, you guys found pretty good beds. They're pretty good. So you both walk...
Great.
So you both get up, you both start walking around a bit, and then you both eventually make it back to... If I can find where it is... Da, 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 da. Okay, pretend that that's not what you're seeing right now.
Hey, it's the bridge!
Yeah.
Pretend that's not that.
Pretend
just
it's
pretend
this. It. There you go.
Wait. What am I looking at?
Alright.
I'm looking at a fucking...
We're back.
Beware of snakes.
What? Oh yeah, that's what he was standing on.
Why was he standing on a square of snakes?
Why not?
Is it Horcruxes? Is that a bunch of Naginis?
No. They're just like dead snakes. Dead snake skins and whatnot.
Why? That's cruel.
So anyway, you two meet up here, like, oh hey, how's it going? How's it going?
Back to the couch.
Alright, you're back on the couch.
Couch is great. Right. Couch is great, no one's here. Couch is great, no one's here.
Arm, what shall you be doing?
I'm gonna sit on the couch too.
Alright. Chris, do you allow this to happen?
As they vegetate for the next 20 days.
I'm gonna allow it to happen, but then actively scoot away from him.
Alright.
Friend zoned again!
What
there we go.
That sound?
It's me moving shit. Fuck.
Ah, I see.
Alright, so.
Mm-hmm. So it is at this point in time that everybody starts trickling in. First one to come in is. Nina. She comes in from here, like, eh. Still tired.
Oh, look, it's Nina.
She walks over here, sees that you're on the couch.
Hi, Nina.
Like,
hi, Nina.
Pouts for a second, and then walks away.
Oh, you stole her
Nina,
couch.
No, wait. Wait, Nina, come back.
She goes behind the curtain.
Nina, come back.
Okay, that's fine.
Blame it all on Ian.
Yeah. Next up is what? Gonzo.
He's like, does he also go behind the curtain?
Who knows? Yeah, morning. How's it hanging?
Good morning, Mr. Gonzo.
You guys ready for a day of adventure and shit?
Not particularly.
No. Alright. Well, get ready within like minutes or so. We're probably gonna go out in like minutes or so. Yeah.
Oh. Great.
Coolio. My bros. And Gonzo goes back there. And Ron shows
like
up.
Sims.
He's like, yo, newbies.
Okay. Hi. Tell you, Ron. Do you know who's in charge of, like, the inventory of, like, weapons and stuff?
Oh, that's Jason. I want to talk to
him.
Oh,
okay.
You should be getting up in like a minute or two. I don't know.
Okay.
Alright.
Alrighty.
Cool. And he also goes behind the curtain. And Jason shows up. Almost on cue.
Hey. Hey, Jason.
Oh, yeah. Hey, how's it going?
Buddy.
Girl, okay.
You, hey, are you allowed to give us anything, or do we need to, like, earn stuff?
Moto's probably gonna give you guys stuff when, you know, sends you out or something. We usually don't, like, carry anything on us while we're in here, because we don't really need to. Anyway, talk to you later. Bye!
Is anyone else concerned about, like, the temperature of the room if they have a fully working forge in there?
Absolutely not.
I don't think anybody. I don't think they would leave it going on in the middle of the night. At least not actively. They might have just let it fucking die down over the night. It's probably
you
near
really
dead.
Can't let a forge die down because those shits are hard. You really have to maintain them.
Yeah, it's very. When a forge goes quiet, it's very very difficult to get back to its temperature again.
Not my problem. Not my
issue.
Takes
like fucking 10 minutes to heat a pot of water on a conventional stovetop. This shit melts iron.
And
you have a sofa sitting opposite of it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sweating through your fucking armor.
Anyway, that guard from last night walks in as well.
Hi. Hey.
As he walks up to you and starts to get closer, you can see that his face is all bloodied and, like, bulbousy. Like, it's... Oh. It's... He's got bruises all over the place. He's not even actually wearing his guard uniform anymore. It looks like he's just wearing some tattered and beaten up cloth.
Is he somehow bound, or is he just straight up walking around? But it looks like shit.
It looks like he's in an extremely dirty toga that also seems to have blood on it.
No, but is he bound? Is his arms tied behind his back, or is he just straight up walking around?
Yeah, no, he's just straight up walking around.
And oh, okay.
He tries speaking with you, and it's a muffled, like, hey, toga.
Oh, hi. Sorry about what happened to you. I have no idea what this organization is, truly. I didn't think they would do that to you. I didn't have any idea they would do that to you. I mean, my intent, as long as you surrendered, it would have been entirely 100% fine. I would just let you go on with a few questions, but... Looks like they might have taken it a bit far.
Thank you for that. I'm gonna go now. You can see that Nina has, poked her head out of the curtain. And he immediately, goes back there as well.
Necks are gonna be snipped.
At which point you see somebody new.
Wasn't her name Carrie?
Yep.
That's literally, I can't tell you how many times I looked up fucking, Knight or something, and that fucking asset came up. I don't understand it.
Oh, jeez. sizing is not good for this.
So I can vouch that Nick probably did not search specifically for a maid. There's just a shit ton of, not a shit ton of assets. There's so many limited assets.
I actually did look specifically for maid.
Well, you're a piece of shit.
Hi, Ice. Are you Carrie, or are you just an entirely new member that Ron forgot to mention?
Who the hell's asking?
Oh, shit.
Right here. Harmony. My new member.
Yeah, I'm Carrie. How's it hanging?
Hi.
Friend.
Okay, I guess.
So this one's have to ask, is Carrie a girl, or...
Yes, Carrie is a girl. I'm not doing a girl voice, because you guys are like, girl voices suck.
I made a declaration that any character
Your girl voices suck.
Yeah.
Anyway, she does, talk in that tone, though. Like, yeah, okay, sure, asshole. She doesn't actually say asshole, but... implied heavily.
Okay. Well, hello.
So you guys coming or what?
I don't know. As far as I'm told, I'm not supposed to go behind those curtains.
No. You're fine. You're part of the group and whatnot. Just get back here. Now. Everyone else is already there, probably.
Pieces. Okay.
And as she's walking away, you can hear muffling under her breath, like, fucking pieces of shit. Get the fuck over here, piece of motherfucking.
Okay.
She's not very kind, is she?
No. None of these claw members are.
I agree with you there.
You know what the claw needs? Some claws.
I'm getting to that in a second.
You'll probably fit in so fucking well.
Until, they're all dead.
How did we even get into this? It's okay. We went from tyrannical asshole that controls the kingdom, from what Claw has told us, to a group of assholes trying to throw over that asshole. Just a kingdom of assholes.
Well, great. You never know with these types of people. Any case?
I have yet to see a noble soul in this fucking department.
You can see that everybody's congregating under a person right here. And they're
a blue-haired maid as well?
No, there's not. yet. Dang it.
Hey.
You fucking kidding me? Stop. I know what you're fucking doing. Shut up.
What am I doing?
No. No. I heard what Dominic said, and it doesn't need to happen. It doesn't make things any better.
I mean, they could also be twins.
Fuck you! No!
Are they demons?
Move along!
They could also be demons. One of them has a horn, the other doesn't. What? No way! I mean, obviously. You don't even have to say it. Anyway, everybody's like congregated down here. They're all like chit-chatting while this guy appears just like sitting there like, eh, I'm a guy. Meh. Gary walks up to him and is, like, pokes him, like, hey, 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 hey.
Oh, wait.
Hey.
Forgot to ask this question. Hey. So, can we get, so, you told us the hotness scale for Nina and Gonzo last time. Let's get a hot, can we get the hotness scale for, like, everyone else in this room?
Sure.
You know he doesn't actually roll those.
Oh, no, I did. At least for Gonzo and Nina.
Now I guess to roll the other ones right now.
Like, Gonzo's a 19, Nina's a 23.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah, Nina's pretty hot.
Exactly the same as me.
Is it really?
You know this stat is entirely arbitrary and useless?
I mean, of course.
No, it is. It is.
Like, Chris was a...
Why did this?
Chris was a fucking 28. Because it's fun. That's Ta-da. Why.
Great. Arbitrary numbers that are never used for anything are fun.
No, it was used once, and I imagine he'll use it once again. Maybe every other time we do D&D. He'll use it once just to remind us it exists.
I mean, it comes up when you guys are, like, talking to other people and, you know, trying to convince them of something, you know, maybe want to bang them or something, you know, that kind of stuff. Okay, so...
All right.
Carrie is a fucking 31. Goddamn.
Oh.
She is smoking. on the other hand, Jason down there is a... 12.
Oh, wow.
For reference sake, Grant. The lowest before this was Ian at a 19.
Wasn't Ian the bear not... lower than me?
Nope, bear was higher than you.
I am higher than you by 4.
And then Ron is a solid 23 as well.
23 seems to be the fucking average. Mm-hmm.
And all then right. the guy right here is...
Is the name Moto? Yeah.
Moto. Or so you Moto. Presume. Moto
Quasi?
Is a 26.
Right. Good
Quasi.
To know.
So all we got from this is that Ian is below average.
And so is Jason. Yes.
Jason is far below average.
Very.
He's the fucking hunchback from Notre Dame.
Oh, yes, the guard as well.
Quasimodo.
I'm pretty sure the guard's at a negative 5 at this point.
I mean, his current hotness is a little below average, but you can kind of, like, see through that and see that his usual hotness is around, say, a 21. Well, right now he's looking like he's a 2.
Oh, okay. I was going to say, does he speed up? Does he still look better than Ian or Gonzo? I mean, or, okay, so I know
actually,
he
he's more of like a 9 because he has like rocking abs and whatnot. You know, arms are like muscly muscles and whatnot.
Okay.
He's still a really damn looking dude.
Well, and how come we beat him up so easily?
I mean. How hot you look doesn't necessarily have a direct effect on your stats.
Then what the fuck is the point?
You were just saying that he was all, like, buff and muscular, and then, like, he is somehow higher than me as a base.
I mean, he looks strong, is what I'm trying to say. That doesn't necessarily mean that he is strong.
Strong and muscular does not equate to any form of, like, vanity. Like, you could be strong and muscular, but look like a complete piece of shit in the face.
True, but I told you that his face was what was messed up, so I was focusing on the other parts of him that did look good.
Like, you could look like Nick, and it's like, that's a total turnoff, right?
Wow. Just goes so, straight after the DM. Goes straight after the Dungeon Master.
So, I go out with my grandparents on Friday nights, because I, like, see them on Fridays, you know, we go
out and
have dinner.
They also call you a nothing piece of shit?
No, but I'm getting to something. So, we go to this place, it's like Italian food, it's delicious, you know. I eat my food, then I go to the bathroom, I'm pissing at the urinal, you know, as you do. At which point, this other guy comes in, and at this point, I, like, finish peeing, and he starts a conversation with me, like, nothing better than, pissing or sex, right? And I was like,
what the fuck?
And I was like, yeah, I've accomplished one of those things. Pissing, that's it. And he's like,
no,
well,
you've never pissed before. You only had sex.
And always he was sex. Like, well, one day you'll have sex. You're a big guy. You look pretty good.
And you know that's called common courtesy, right?
But it was like the tone that he said it in. It was really creepy.
Oh, no, it wasn't the other thing.
It especially
wasn't
since,
up a conversation.
I mean, consider, like, who does that?
That guy.
Like, who just walks up to somebody like, hey, pissing's pretty good, right?
I'll be honest. Going to the bathroom is pretty fun. If I could recreationally shit, I'd do it.
Goddamn.
You can. Get a toilet installed. Just get an actual toilet installed in your room, and then you can just sit
well, I mean,
there and
like,
be like...
You only use the bathroom when you have to.
That is literally the one interaction I have ever had with another person in a bathroom. And it was so weird.
Just take medicine, and eventually you'll be shitting for your life.
Yeah, you know,
yeah,
laxatives.
Yeah, then I'll just, you know, getting rid of my innards and, you know... die an early death, and that'll be great.
Yay!
I can be with Harambe. Dicks out.
God damn. Anyway, Moto is up here, and he's like, silence!
Ow.
And it's a very booming, loud voice. You can see that, Moto is looking, you know, he's, well, hot, of course. But he's also, you know, kind of...
very important.
Yes, you can see that he's literally multiple steps above you. Like, you guys on the are on the first floor, you literally have to look up to him to actually, like, see his face and whatnot. And even then, there's, like, an overcast of a shadow on him. Like, he looks mysterious.
That is called egotistical architecture.
Mm-hmm. So, we are in the worst fucking organization.
So, Gonzo, who are these two? Oh, well, the name's Ahamini. That's girl. Points to you, Chris. And that's Sir Arm. Pretty decent in the fight. They're the guys that I went to the castle and found, and they were like... I mean, there's also Bear there, but he kind of fucked off somewhere. And so, yeah, those two are the guys. Or girls. Girl and guy. Yeah. So.
Hi.
You two are willing to help us overthrow the corrupt King Paul. I would take that to assume.
It depends.
I mean, do you really have a reason to? Let's be straight.
Well, yeah. I mean, I know literally nothing about your organization, literally nothing about this land, other than what your group has told me. I would, you know, I don't know.
All right. Then let me inform you on the current state of this country.
Bye.
Okay. Is it a song? No.
Well,
we are currently in a great depression.
Shit. It's happening.
It's going really bad. The king is a corrupt man, and we need to kill him so we can grow mushrooms or something. I lost it.
There's a place I know that's tucked away, a place where you and I could stay, a place where we could laugh and play that and have adventures every day. I know it sounds
hard to believe,
guys and gals, it's true.
Are you fucking... kidding me?
Pamplin's the place for me and you.
It's actually it's
actually... Please, no, I'm just listening to my own music.
Alright. It's actually so I don't country. Have to hear this. It's actually Country Carnegie is the name.
What?
Country Carnegie.
Oh, Country Carnegie is the place for you and me. Okay.
Yeah. That is. That is the country you that guys are currently true. In. Carnegie is the place. The country is named after our king, Paul of Carnegie, as well as his house, House Carnegie. They have ruled over this country for many a year. So far back that we don't even remember. It's been basically forever.
House Carnegie? Do they always repay a debt?
Who knows?
But
I'm assuming that's fucking
Lannister.
Game of Thrones thing?
A Lannister always repays his debts.
Alright then.
Yes.
So yes, dating back so far, we can't even remember the last time our country was not ruled by Carnegie. So, as such, the Carnegies have great power. Most of the time, well, all the time, besides, well, Paul. It's been fine, you know. You know, the Carnegies have been a very nice royal family. They've been great political leaders and whatnot, but once the old king died, John Paul Carnegie, when Paul Carnegie took over, it did not go very well with the people for some reason. He received many backlashes for many things that he did, which many of the previous kings have done, but have not received backlash for, which is strange, but at the same time, does not make sense as well. So, yeah, redundancy. And as such, he has kind of rebelled against the rebelling of his people. He has raised taxes, he has locked many people inside, but for the most part, foreign relations are what kills him the most. We currently have no contact with any outside country, and as such, our trade endeavors and, you know, food endeavors are kind of on the downslope.
Let me guess, there's a border, and it's heavily protected.
Not necessarily.
Is there a barrier of some kind?
Nope.
So,
alright, leave the country. Let's go.
So, yeah, that's the thing. So, how big is this organization, really?
What you see here, and about three others.
And,
technically speaking, that guard isn't in part of this.
Yeah, no, guard is not part of this, I assume, unless they fucking beat him into it. Hey, so we're gonna kill you now unless you join us, and then they beat him to death.
So Moto,
historically, it's not well.
So Moto looks over at Gonzo and is like, you did tell them that we are a small organization that really has a little chance of winning, correct? And he's like, yeah, I did. I told him, like, hey, you can stay there or you can come with us. I don't really care. He's like, okay, I'm just making sure. So you do know that we're small, correct?
Yes.
Nope. Zero fucking idea.
Okay, well, now you know.
Good.
So yes, our goal is to take down the corrupt King Carnegie. Ways in which we will do this, we are working on many angles. You two will be working on one of those such angles today with Jason. Actually, no, Ron. Ron, right? Yeah, Ron. So
a few members, but he can't remember their names. Well.
So Arm, Harmony, and Ron, you three are going to go to the shopping district to meet up with Jana. He is...
That's not a name we totally just came up on the spot.
We are... Are we... Just noting this, we kind of, more or less, kind of broke out of his prison, did we not?
Oh, well, you see, the thing is, he doesn't really care. Like, he puts up this big show of like, oh yes, we have to catch those escapees, and then the next day it's like, you guys never escaped at all. Like, he just, I guess, pretends that you guys are still there, or just forgets that you even ever escaped. Like, posters have gone up before for many a person who have gone in and then gotten out, but you still see those people around town, and basically all the posters are gone.
I just realized something.
Uh-huh.
What?
This is basically the plot line to Akame ga Kill.
You're sure. Actually kind of right.
Huh.
Never fucking watched it.
You still just can't not rip off anime, huh?
There isn't, like, a corrupt grandfather or anything, right? Like, corrupt
grandfather
we know.
Well, so I haven't seen the end of that shit yet, still.
Oh, alright. A year later. Huh. There are some similarities, yeah.
Majority of
there are some similarities, yeah.
I don't know.
Nick, we're not thinking ahead.
I didn't mean to rip it off.
Yeah.
We need a DM is not prepared count.
I mean,
no, we need a DM is a ripoff piece of shit. Fucking
that too.
That's at like 6 now, isn't it?
He's Jewing it.
Jewing it. Alright. Sure. Anyway, yes, he continues talking about, like, oh yeah, the person. What was your question again, Harmony?
Oh, we're just talking about the size of the organization. Then you were going about mission details, I guess?
Right, alright, so.
I'm Harmony, not entirely sold on that.
Harmony, Arm, Ron, you three, since, well, the kingdom's probably forgotten that you even exist at this point. You three are going to be going to the shopping district to meet up with Jana. He will be supplying funds for our endeavors. You'll need to go back, and he points like all the way to this back room back here, and grab some of the supplies which we will be selling to him, to which we will get money in exchange. Inanna, Jason, Gonzo, you three are going to be taking this guard dude and doing stuff with him. You know, figuring out, like, strategies to attack the castle and whatnot. All right. Harmony, Arm, this is your first mission. Don't fuck it up. Sound good? Great. Everybody, break.
Great.
So, yes, he claps, and everybody, like, starts running off and whatnot.
Man.
Plot development.
This is also not ripping off other things. Keep ripping off.
What is he ripping off here?
Fucking, look at the Mystery Dungeon series, where, like, every morning, everyone fucking pops out, and then the guy's like, yeah, so you guys are gonna go do shit, right? And everyone goes, yeah! And he goes, alright, go do shit! And then everyone fucking goes on and does their shit, and it's like...
Alright, well, I'm gonna say he's probably never played Mystery Dungeon.
I have never played Mystery Dungeon.
Too bad. It's a thing that exists. I've never watched a comic get killed, but apparently you ripped it off. Apparently.
Yeah, but Nick has, and he's making the game. That's more relevant.
Yes, I watched the entirety of Comic Got Killed. That is true.
Apparently, a lot of people don't like it.
I mean,
I found it a good anime.
It was.
It's just that a lot of characters died.
He just said he didn't finish the anime, and you go,
Trust me. I already know that much.
I mean, that was literally the best part of the show. Like, every character could die.
And every character.
And did.
Every character, but, you know, the titular. The tight. I don't know what the fucking.
Akame exactly never died, if I was going to guess.
Yeah, no, she doesn't die. She doesn't die.
Or does she?
She's the title character, and therefore. Well, I mean, title characters can die, but in this one, they don't.
Hey, W0.
I mean, he comes, isn't that the fucking gimmick of the show, though? It's a fucking, like, thing. He dies, but then, oh, guess what? Reset, motherfucker. Aha.
Rebirth by death or something like that?
It's returned by death, yes.
It's like, live, die, repeat the anime, except, live, die, repeat the anime, except way better than the fucking movie.
Live, die, repeat, become increasingly mentally unstable, the anime.
Wait, wasn't that movie called Edge of Tomorrow?
Sure.
It was.
I know it was a movie and it existed, and apparently I think it did so bad that they changed the name when they released it for DVD.
Yeah. It was Edge of Tomorrow. Yeah, why not?
Nope. They can do that. Fucking shit. They can't it's their shit. They can release it whatever the fuck they want.
Anyway,
welcome to the podcast.
The only thing I don't give a fuck. Listen.
Harmony. You guys want to, like, respond at all or, like, just go with the flow?
I guess I can go along with it for now. I don't have a whole lot of other options.
Alright. So everybody breaks and everybody starts, like, rushing out. Like, hey, let's go.
You can snap them next and then heal them.
Let's go do shit. Yay! So now we come back to here. As long as I could fucking have it in the right place at the right time. Yay. Bada bing. Oh, look.
You know, like...
Iggy's still sleeping there.
Okay. Now get back to them.
So he's still sleeping there.
Yeah.
Nope. He's gonna wake
up. Thanks for the update with pictures.
I mean, they come out of there and they're like, oh, there's a bear here. It's sleeping.
With pants.
Yes, it has pants on. Ooh, ah, very frightening. Oh, do a la di da.
Okay.
So, do you guys have any response to the bear being there or what? Like, come on.
Nope. Oh, there's a bear there. Let's not wake it up.
Isn't that the bear from yesterday?
Did you suddenly become English?
I'm trying to do voices.
Suddenly did. There's no point.
Oh, yeah.
Cheers, love!
Cavalry's here!
I'm never doing that again.
Please don't. Anyway.
Please don't. Do that.
Gonzo's like, yeah, I think that is it. And he's like, walks up to you, like, hey there, little bear, how's it going? And he starts, like, petting you on the back, which wakes you up, by the way.
Oh, please tell me he snaps.
His petting is, like, a medium. Like, it's not the best, not the worst. It's decent enough.
So. Stone face.
The bear of death.
Act as you will.
Stone face.
Alright, well... let's see. Ron? Where the fuck is Ron?
He's there, I just need to grab his token.
Alright, Ron.
That's so easy, is it?
I guess we're going to the marketplace, right?
Hey,
marketplace?
Can't wait till we get to town. Then I'm gonna fucking collect a barrel and a fucking eagle and a fucking onion. I'm gonna have you bring their tokens fucking everywhere.
They are huge. There we go.
I have no recollection of the onion I want.
It's just saying I'm gonna have tokens that Nick has to fucking carry over map to map because his fucking birdcage in the other game.
I've given up all hope at this point.
So, what was your question, Harmony? Or...
I thought you were like a fucking optimist.
Nope.
Comments.
Listen, you can only push you can only push someone so far before they just stop. Nothing.
How you can only turn it neck so far before it snaps.
So, Mr. Bearson, what are you doing here? Just staring stone-faced cold?
Uh-huh.
Alright. So Ron... Ron walks up to the bear and is like, oh hey, there's a bear here. And he also starts petting you.
And he pets the bear.
Yeah.
Well, everyone wants.
So, how long are you going to let them pet you? Just forever?
I'm not moving.
Alright, so... They stand there for a solid, like, 20 minutes just petting you. Nina is talking to the guard guy. Jason is also over there, like, talking.
I'm just looking through rubble and seeing what there is.
Alright. Harmony?
Apparently weapons for you.
There's nothing.
Do I do a roll for, like, looking for random stuff?
Oh my god.
Wood.
There's nothing in there.
A story.
You
there's
can
wood. I mean, like, congratulations.
Are you gonna get endless? I mean, like, supply of basically anything.
Listen, you're not gonna find the cursed sword of fucking Kazarthamoth. It's just wood.
I mean, if you do, no, it's gonna, like, stab you through and die.
Oh, yeah, I still have my burnt piece of wood.
Sure.
That could be the only thing burnt by the end of this.
Another 10 minutes go by, they just keep petting you, at which point Nina walks over and also starts petting you.
I thought she was afraid of me.
This is like the equivalency to making ravioli.
Alright, fucking, except it's every episode. Fucking, when Nina comes, I'm gonna turn towards her.
Alright, turn. She keeps petting you.
That wasn't a deterrent for anything?
Like, she keeps...
20 solid minutes of just petting, and suddenly there's motion, and no one is surprised. Like, no one is surprised there's a bear.
She just keeps petting you on the head instead of the butt now.
Except I had pants on.
I know. She's petting the butt still.
Why are you fucks not doing anything?
Shouldn't we be going now?
Ron and Gonzo.
I don't know why this fucking rebellion's not getting anywhere. They fucking get sidetracked so easy.
Ron and Gonzo are like, oh shit, yeah. Like, Gonzo remember. Gonzo's like, oh yeah, we should probably. It's like 1 in the afternoon now, right? Yeah, shit, we. Oh yeah, let's go. And he just, like, walks off, you know, kind of. Trying to pretend that didn't just happen.
Man, this is so going to your boss.
In any case. Down! Yes! Mwaha!
It's the world map.
It is. Because you're traveling long distances.
It looks like we're going to a fucking... another forge.
What do you mean, another forge? Oh, no, that's not a forge.
Another forge.
That is how
it means what he says, it's another forge.
So, Iggy, are you following them as they walk?
Yep.
Alright. So, Gonzo turns to you guys and, like, hey, you just gonna let that bear come along? I mean, he's a pretty cool bear, to be honest. We don't want to get in turn or anything, do we?
I believe the bear can take care of itself.
I have no qualms about this.
Alright.
I have no qualms about this.
Sure. So Ron, Iggy, not Gonzo, hang on. Harmony, you four are walking this way.
That river. I swear.
Well, the other four... go that way.
The greatest river.
Into the darkness. You have no idea where they are. Yes. So, you guys walk around for a bit until you are able to find something that resembles a stable. At this point, you guys just followed Ron for an amount of time. Probably about, like, an hour or so. Until you guys were able
probably
to...
Probably about, like, an hour or so. Yeah. Who knows? Doesn't even know.
Until you guys were able to find a stable of some sort. And he's like, alright, now, I'm gonna...
Gasp.
Jason, you piece of shit.
Jason is apparently... Hey,
what had happened? What happened? Sorry. I wasn't paying attention.
We were supposed to grab some supplies to, you know, trade with, Shana.
Oh, I mean, maybe if we didn't get sidetracked with petting the bear.
And Jason was supposed to remind me before we left, like, hey, get the stuff. Fucking Jason!
I mean...
It's a piece of shit.
Isn't this on you, too?
No, I specifically reminded him!
Motto was right there. He said, go do the things. And then we all went out, and you guys pet the bear for 20 minutes.
Specifically reminded him.
This is...
I mean, how could he forget like that? Seriously, Jason's such a piece of shit. Anyway, we gotta go back and get it. You know what? Alright. I will go back and get it. You guys go into town. Alright, there, we're meeting him at this,
No, okay.
Convenient split tactics!
We're meeting him at this, fountain in the middle of, like, the shopping district, alright?
Yeah, you cut out for me? Where were we
meeting? We're meeting him at a fountain in the middle of the shopping district, alright? You can't miss it. So just stay around there. He probably won't show up for, like, another 2 hours, so... You guys just walk around. Just make sure that you are at the fountain when those, like, 2 hours
have, like... Why don't we just go back with you?
Because he could show up earlier. Wait, you can't
Nick doesn't
talk.
Think that far ahead. Nick does not think that far ahead. He just knows shit's happening right now.
He could have had us teleport there, and then we would have had no way back. But, you know.
I mean, maybe you did. Who knows?
Okay. So, you want us to be in the middle of the market that we have never been to before, so we don't even know if we can get to the middle of it or what the middle of the market
is. It's a fountain. And you want us to get to a fountain.
Are there spirits in it?
But we don't know. Are there multiple fountains? Or is there just
There's only one fountain in the shopping district, all right? Just get to the shopping district. Walk around for a while. I don't care. He gives you, like, a bag of gold.
Shopping district, not, like, the fucking residential district.
All right. I'll take that bag of gold. All right.
He gives you a bag of gold. Like, here. Split between you two and the bear, I guess. I don't know. And, like, buy shit. I don't care. It's, like, probably, like, 50 gold there or something.
Doesn't need money. Fairly sure the bear doesn't need has no need of currency, but
you guys probably need like supplies and all since you guys are like, you know, just fresh in, which we probably should have been supplies back in the house.
Gonna
whatever.
Hold out my paw to the fucking bag of gold.
I think he wants his share.
Honestly, what are you going to buy? If you're gonna buy anything, there's no way they're gonna give it to you. So you might as well just stick with one of us, and
we'll keep my paw held out.
Ron's like, anyway, you guys sort that out. I'll be back in like an hour or two with the stuff. All right, I'll be back.
Apparently 2 hours.
All right. Well, give me a sec, Mr. Bear. All right, how much gold do we have in this bag?
All right, you look in the bag, and there is 60 gold in it.
That is 20 apiece.
In case you couldn't do that. There's 60
gold. Great. 60 gold. That's fine. Alright, well, I don't know where you're going to keep this. So here's 20 gold.
I'm good. Here's what's going to happen. I'm just going to make up the lore for this as it goes. Fucking... I put the gold on my back and it just starts sinking into my fur.
So now we're ripping off Steven Universe.
A little bit.
Yep.
No, not a little bit, a lot.
I have to admit that wasn't my intention, but as soon as I said it, I'm like, huh, that's kind of like Lion.
What was that? Wasn't your intention?
Hey, listen, I didn't rip off John's fucking shield.
I didn't mean to either.
What? Where does that come from?
Base game.
This game? When the fuck did that happen?
Space game.
Space.
Oh, the space game. Wait, when did that happen?
Ian got a shield. It fucking extended.
Oh, right. Right, right, right.
Anyway. I'm also not a shitty DM. That's actually relative.
Anyway, you guys are still at the stable. And so...
Alright. Well, I'm going to town.
Yeah.
You guys... Also, Chris, you watch Steven Universe?
No. I keep tabs on it. It's an interesting thing. I'd like to watch it, maybe, but then I kind of don't want to watch it because there's probably a decent amount of... I mean, because it's like a kid's cartoon show. There's probably a decent amount of episodes that don't actually mean a whole lot to the overarching plot.
Oh, yeah. There's a few of those.
So it's like... I feel like I'm content with just more just reading shit online about it. Rather than actually
like,
watching
the show.
There's
literally an episode where it's like a crossover with another cancerous show from Cartoon Network, and it's awful.
What show?
Uncle Grandpa's not that like, bad.
I think it's Uncle Grandpa. It's awful.
It's not
oh,
that
God,
bad.
Oh, God, no.
I have watched like 3 episodes of it. It wasn't the worst thing in the world.
It's okay, really- listen. For some reason, side tangent, why does every fucking cartoon nowadays have to have a character or multiple characters that sounds like fucking Patrick Starr? I always hated his voice. And every fucking character in these new cartoons has to have a shit-faced character.
I mean, they're usually somewhat funny, but the way Patrick Starr was pulled off is pretty hard to do. Like, he...
Patrick's character was done well.
Yeah.
His voice was atrocious. Everyone's ripping off that voice and making it worse. It sucks.
Yeah. Like, they look at Patrick Starr and they're like, his voice was obviously the thing that was holding the entire character together, when in reality it was the writing that was holding the entire character together. Anyway.
Pod tangent over.
Yeah. Uncle Grandpa, not that bad.
Hey, podcast.
Yeah.
Tomorrow. Today.
Yeah. So you guys walking for a while, and you make it to shopping district. You see many a vendor out, like, hello!
Oh, yes, my favorite town, shopping district.
Yes, shopping district, favorite town. Fun fact, that is actual name. You guys walk up to shop district, and you
fun
see...
Fun fact, why you sound racist?
And you see signs that say, shopping district. Of course, you cannot...
Why you sound so racist, Antonio?
Of course,
you... Oh, how wrong!
Of course, you're unable to read language of this world. Except I joke...
Really?
Ha-ha, ha-ha, ha-ha. I jokey joke about the wordy words on the signy sign. Ha-ha, ha-ha. But yes.
We're all gonna burn in hell.
Signs say.
No. Only Nick is. He's a racist.
Signs say shopping district.
No. Fairly sure we're all gonna burn in hell. There's 0 point to anyone here going to heaven.
Alright, you see many a vendor there. That you see, basically think.
Is there a boy vendor?
Is there a boy vendor?
A boy vendor?
What?
There, as far as you can tell, there's not a toy vendor.
Well, shit.
He was making fluff. He was making a joy. He was making a joke to the Fluffle card, I think.
Toy vendor.
Anyway, you guys start walking into the shopping district. There is no like all-encompassing wall to like strictly dictate like this is the area where the shopping district is. So.
All right. So
hang on.
You know,
let me continue to
because it's entirely. No, fuck you. Alright, so, alright, team. Or, Arm and Bear.
I mean,
so.
Alright.
Yep, kind of expected that. Okay, Arm. I'm gonna leave too. Bye.
Like, still in the shopping district, but you know, off.
Yeah.
I'm gonna leave too. Bye. And all I'm right. gonna also leave.
So, who does what first?
I guess we'll just go in order.
Do we roll initiative for that or what?
So, Dominic moved first.
Yeah.
So Dominic.
Go ahead.
Dominic, it's all up to you.
I want to see if there's any form of, like, apothecary or herbologist.
You walk around for
herbalist?
A bit, and you find a vendor with a green, like, overtop on him. Like, all these vendors don't actually have, like, buildings dedicated
Wares?
To them. It's just a stall.
Like stalls?
Yeah,
like
stalls.
It's like a market where, like, you kind of just buy a stall, set up your shit, and hopefully nobody takes your spot when you come back the next day.
Yeah.
Have you seen, like, the Indian markets where literally they're built, like, where trains go through? So, like, when trains come through, they literally have to pull their shit in. And then as soon as the train leaves, they put it back out.
Yep.
No.
Nope. Crazy. Never seen that before, but I have when...
But yes, there's...
Like, I did that vacation thing over winter break, and when New Year's rolled around, like, every street was just literally just filled with people selling fireworks. If you wanted fireworks, you were not gonna not find fireworks. If you somehow didn't have fireworks for New Year's, it was just like an oddity. And then what's even weirder is that was like the day before New Year's, and so, like, lots of fireworks and shit was shot off, and, like, my family bought a shit ton of fireworks. We were like, fuck it, we're in the Philippines, shit is kind of semi cheap over here, we'll just buy a shit ton of fireworks and set them off. And so we set a good portion of them off, and we're like, we should get more. And then next day we go to look for them, no one is fucking selling fireworks.
What?
Everyone that was is gone. They just somehow all disappeared, and it was like, how the fuck did that? That was a quick turnover. Everyone had them one day, and now no one.
Gotta adapt, I guess.
We could not find any. No, but this was like a day turn. One day, fucking everyone and their mother had fireworks for sale. Next day, you can't find fireworks anywhere.
I mean, supply
and demand. Somehow,
they
just all disappeared. Supply and demand doesn't mean fucking the product disappears the next day.
Demanded it on that day, and then...
That is adaptive selling. That's adaptive fucking marketing.
Yeah. Supply dwindled incredibly quickly.
So quick, though. We were just so disappointed. We should have bought more fireworks, even though we spent, like, easily 100 US on fireworks over there.
What?
Listen! The exchange rate's stupid, so it's like, fuck it. We'll just buy a ton of fireworks.
Yeah, fun with it, at least.
Had tons of fun with it. We had tons of fun with the fireworks. I just really wish we could have gotten more. Because it was like, yeah, we could get more fireworks. And I was like, yeah, more fireworks. Oh, no one's selling them anywhere. That's okay.
Oh, darn.
Anyway. Fucking apothecary, drug dealer, whatever
yes,
it is.
There is a green canopy covering this person's stall. It seems that...
Wow, okay.
This person is indeed a male. They look pretty... They look like they're in their mid-40s. They have a pretty long black beard on them. Hotness? Sure.
Yeah. If you're gonna fucking put the stupid system in it, I'm gonna make you use it whenever it fucking comes up.
Holy shit!
Every time, basically
like,
every time we ever interact.
Is he a fucking Patrick Star, or is he like a Squilliam?
Like a Matthew McConaughey.
I have no idea who that is.
I don't know.
Me either.
Very hot guy, I guess, who's like an actor. Anyway,
he's an actor.
His hotness is a...
He's an actor.
His hotness is a 40.
Well, good luck doing anything to that guy.
Yeah, no, this guy is like the paragon of hotness. Like, whatever the perfect man you can think of is, this is that guy. No, slick
Harambe.
He looks like Harambe.
Harambe was Monkey Jesus, yeah.
He is, whatever. Like, the very... Like, if you looked up in a dictionary, like, hotness, this guy is it. He has solid, like, jet black hair, all slicked back and such. He's carrying around a cigar that he's currently smoking. He has very, like, well, his clothing does look quite rugged. It also accentuates his physical features. For instance, his face has, like, a rock-hard jaw line, which is accentuated by his, which is then accentuated by his shirt. He has a rugged feel to him, but at the same time, that rugged feel is,
Listen, Squilliam is the epitome of hotness, and you don't know what you're talking about if you disagree.
He's a fucking squid.
I mean, William Fancyson, motherfucker.
I mean, if he was calamari, then he would be hot, yes.
Calamari doesn't necessarily have to be hot, though. Moving on.
Yes, he is the epitome of hottie hot 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 hot.
Cool. It's actually completely irrelevant in this.
It is.
He has many an herb on him. Or included in his wares.
Alright, so I go up to this apparently fucking David Hasselhoff of a man.
Mm-hmm.
I have no idea who David Hasselhoff is. It sounds like someone.
He was in the movie.
He was in the SpongeBob movie.
He was
movie,
in
yes.
the SpongeBob movie.
Oh, he was!
Yeah.
The lifeguard.
That's
dude.
How I know today.
He I'm was David the lifeguard. Did you guys ever see that the newest SpongeBob movie though?
There's another one.
No.
It was like
Sponge Out of Water.
Yeah.
Some shit like that.
I didn't see it.
It was incredibly.
I opted out of not watching that.
It was incredibly stupid.
I can see
Isn't most things SpongeBob incredibly stupid?
Most of these days, yes.
I mean, they've already given up on the show.
But they physically stop because Nickelodeon's like, we need to milk you past the point of like you have nothing left. We're gonna beat you so hard the dead horse is gonna look like it's been getting a pedicure.
No, but they actually gave up. That was a thing, or unless they restarted it up again. But no, that was a thing. They like, we're fucking done. We're not creating anything new. We'll just keep rebroadcasting it till we apparently get the message that we shouldn't.
Pretty sure they're still doing shit.
I think there are still new episodes.
Yeah, they are.
How many episodes can you write about a sponge underwater?
Detective Conan.
Well played.
I hate everyone.
So, yes, this guy is very hot. He has many an herb on him. Well, in his wares. You see many a different shape of leaf and color. As well as mixtures of potions, as well as a very pungent smell coming from a cauldron that is sitting behind him. And you can see a bit of, like, green.
As I am a bear.
Yes.
And I obviously live in the woods.
Yes.
Do I have any knowledge of poisonous plants and what's not poisonous and all that shit?
You do know of some poisonous plants, yes.
Alright. I'm gonna go up to Mr. fucking Hasselhoff.
Hello there, bear. How are you today?
I'm gonna draw something in the dirt or ground or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna draw that symbol.
Like. Oh. I see. Well, that depends on how much you have.
About 23 golds.
Do you just, like, show him the gold?
Yes.
Wait, how much did you say you had?
23.
23? What?
I looted at a guard I killed. First thing I did?
No, I told you you had 30 from that.
Oh, shit. Okay, I'll pull out fucking 40 of that.
And, yeah, also, Harmony gave you some. Alright.
But, so, yeah, I know. So I have fucking 50 in total. Or, not 50. Yeah, 50 in total.
Alright. You show him 40?
Yeah.
I see. Okay. He looks around for a second, like, making sure there's nobody, like, walking by. Everybody else seems preoccupied with whatever they seem to be doing, you know, there's many a person doing whatever they wish, right, you know, talking about them.
Probably convey what I want. I'm going to find the perfect one, really.
Yes.
Yeah, maybe that.
Huh?
Brother just...
Simmons. Like... A sleeping potion?
More or less.
Okay, yeah. He's like, oh, okay, that makes more sense. Can you count me out 30 of that gold, please?
25. You know, in there.
25, and then you're gonna, like, stare him down?
Yes. Basically, stare him down. You know, persuasion, as it actually is an ability I have.
Yes. You're going to have to roll for that. He does. He has persuasion and stealth style. Persuasion is more effective, so D20 plus 20. Yeah.
Jesus. What do I need?
You're going to need like a... you're going to need like a... 20...
What is he... You're gonna need what does he need to fail this?
23. Yeah, I failed it.
Yep, fail.
Right. Holy shit, you managed to fail this.
Like, he needed a 7 or lower to fail. So that's 7 out of 20.
Yeah.
I'll
fucking give him the 30.
There you go.
No, you can continue to renegotiate. You can continually try until he gets pissed off.
I'm not gonna do that.
He takes
the
30. Keep
staring him down.
He takes the 30.
What do I get?
He gives you a quite small vial. He says,
"Wow,
this may look small, but it is very potent. One drop,
all right,
and they will be out like a light. Or the sun when it sets, I suppose."
I hold up a bare thumbs up.
Now, be very careful. Since it does only take one drop, you don't even have to ingest it. Like, just splashing on it somebody would work.
Bare thumbs up.
God damn it, Nick.
Man, this can only go so well for us.
I fucking absorb it into my bat rolls on my back, I guess, and fucking walk up.
Alright. Pleasure doing business with you. Yeah.
I guess other people can go now.
Yeah. Harmony, do you want to do?
Fuck.
Oh, don't worry.
So okay, let's look for medical supplies. Why not?
So do you also all want to go to an apothecary? Is that what I'm hearing?
No, I just want general medical supplies.
Like, that's an apothecary. Bandages.
Yeah, like in this
sure,
time.
Fucking
all right, so
I went to like a fucking florist/herbologist. Apothecary is like medicine.
I mean, really, herbalist and apothecary kind of go hand in hand in this time period.
On the like, you can have your natural medicines and then you have your chemical medicine.
Yeah. Like, the guy you went to did both, and in that case, the guy shows up for you again, Harmony. Now, again.
And your ovaries explode.
Yes. He is the literal.
Oh, hi, sir. I'm just looking for some. Medical supplies?
I will be right back.
Alright. He licks his lips and is like, of what sort?
The healing sort? You know, I just, you know, I mean...
What are we talking about?
I really...
Lesser? Medium? Greater? Please, go
into I get like a quick rundown of what each of those do. Lesser, medium, greater.
A lesser is exactly what it says. It heals for 2d4.
Okay.
Greater heals for 2d8. Medium heals for 2d8, and then greater heals for 2d12. And also, depending on your wisdom, you get bonuses. For instance, wisdom is high enough, you get like a +3 to the healing effect or whatnot.
Ah, okay. Okay, could you tell me how much each would cost?
Of course. A lesser will cost you 25 apiece.
That's me.
Medium costs
25 apiece. Okay.
Medium costs 50, and greater costs 150.
Okay. Well, now is a good time to mention I never gave Arm his gold, so he's basically goldless. So I have 40 gold. All right. Well, I guess I'll just take a lesser potion then.
Man, I thought you gave me my gold.
Nope, I gave the bear its gold because it fucking threatened me.
I didn't threaten shit. I put my paw out.
That's threatening enough on its own.
You gotta realize your character's a bear.
Nope, okay, fuck you. First off, everyone in this world does not give a single shit that I am a bear. I'm sorry, just go up and bet a fucking bear? No. A bear just walked into a fucking apothecary and bought some fucking weeds. How in the world is that valid?
You're presuming our characters are actually this place.
Woke up in a
our
room
characters magically
fine with it.
Our characters magically appeared in this place, therefore we technically might not even be from this world. So it's entirely based on what we feel like. You know, fucking if I saw a bear, I'm going to be like, yep, nope, this thing's gonna kill me. Well, life was okay. Life was fun.
Well, now I'm a bear with pants and fucking some sleeping potions.
Yeah, no. Bears are fucking intimidating. Bears are fucking intimidating. Yeah, no. Just gonna not. No, yeah, no. You got your money because you fucking were intimidating. Arm didn't get shit because Arm didn't request shit. Yeah, alright. So I buy the... Also, yeah, no, I'll take one lesser potion.
Ah, yes, okay.
Lesser healing.
You give him the 25, he gives you the lesser healing potion. You now have exactly one lesser healing potion.
Okay. Also, could you point me in the... Well, like, do you know where, like, people tend to congregate to talk? In this town? Or are you just like...
Yes, the fountain over there, and he points down the road a bit. You turn left at the intersection and then go straight for about 5 minutes, and you'll reach the fountain. You can't miss it. It's quite a sight.
Oh, okay. Okay. All right, then. That's where I could, like, find general information about the town and such.
Oh, yes.
Right?
There, if you... From the fountain, if you look north, which there's a... compass. Well, there's a directional sign in the square where the fountain is, so you'll be able to find it. If you look north, there will be a fairly big hall that is basically a guild of adventurers, let's say.
Good.
So if you just go inside there, you'll be able to find like odd jobs or whatever you need. Post jobs.
All right, thank you. Thank you for the info and the potion.
Yes, come back anytime. He licks his lips again as you walk away.
Excuse me?
That was disturbing. Why would he lick his lips?
Who knows?
Wait. Okay.
So, Arm, what shall you do since you have no money?
It's broke as a joke.
What's in my inventory?
Burnt wood. You have two swords, I believe.
And all this.
As well as the weapon that you're currently carrying.
So it's three swords.
You can't swords, remember my inventory? How could you?
You can hold up a convenience store.
There's not much. You have three swords, one of which you're using, and a piece of wood.
Burnt piece of wood, yes.
I'm gonna go, like, try to find a forge or something.
Alright. You look around town for a bit. And you find an actual, like, armory type place. That's not, you know, just like a random vendor stall. This is a straight up built place that
it's a smith.
Yes. It's an actual
This is actually like when the town shuts down, you'll be able to find this.
Yeah, there is an actual building here that you walk inside. You walk inside and you see that there are many armory racks. You see that there are many armors, many swords, many lances, especially lots of lances here for some reason.
Oh yeah, I have my barrel shield, don't I?
No, you don't.
You don't have a shield.
The barrel that you're purposing as a
shield?
Oh,
yeah, that.
Oh yeah, that. Sounds so fucking annoyed. Oh yeah, that. That. That thing.
Does the shield actually do anything?
Does the
No, it's a shield. It's a shield. It serves its purpose.
It gives him like 1 AC, yes.
But since it's literally a piece of crap, and I got it from a broken barrel, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, most games start you out with the fucking plankwood shield.
Mm-hmm. And
I started out with no shield.
You find the smith, and he looks kind of like a pansy, to be honest. Again,
pansy smith. The smithening.
He's looking pretty wimpy in the arms. Like, they kind of look like wet noodles, to be honest. His frame is very petite. But he seems to have this aura about him that just, like, exudes... I am a powerful beast, and I will destroy anything that gets in my way. Mwahaha.
Okay. I'm going to show him two of the swords I have and ask him how much I can get for them, and if I can smelt them into something else.
Hello.
Want money for them, and then you want to melt them into something else.
He wants to melt them into ingots and maybe make something else out of them. Who the fuck knows? Let him do his thing.
Hello!
You do your bear things.
Traveler. What have you for me today?
Is he pretentious? He's pretentious as fuck.
Greetings, good sir. I have these swords here that I would like to sell.
Ah, yes. Show them to me, if you will.
I take out two of the swords and I show them to him.
So he grabs one of them, lifts it up in the air, you know, kind of like at the lights to get a pretty good picture of what it looks like. And he's like, oh, huh. These are good quality swords you have here.
How much can I get for them?
I would say, this is like castle quality sword. I would say roughly 100 gold apiece. But, if I may ask, where exactly did you procure these swords?
Oh, wait, really quick.
I got them from a trader over by the bridge.
Go ahead, Chris.
I mean, to be fair, you're at least gonna wanna see how much damage they do. You might wanna not just sell one of them and just sell your current sword and one of the castle swords. Just as entire suggestion. See how much damage.
One thing to
note.
Don't
I have three castle swords?
You have three.
No.
You have three swords total. Wait. The one you're currently using, which was given to you by Gonzo. And then two more.
No, it was given by the other chick. Not that it fucking matters.
Oh, Nina, yeah.
Then which is better, the castle swords or the one I got from Nina?
I mean, are you gonna check?
What?
I was assuming I was already equipped with a better weapon.
Hey, DM! What are the stats? Are you gonna check?
he put them on the table.
No, that's information. That's information you should be giving out. Look, this sword does this much damage.
The
shouldn't
armor,
have to fucking test the sword. Why do we have to
test the
sword?
He didn't check before, so he has to, like, since the guy is currently, like, looking at it, he has to ask him.
He's asking you as the DM. Fucking give him the information or don't.
Or if there's, like, some feasible reason, like, there's a system in place, like, you have to fucking use the sword to figure it out, that's fine.
Like...
Do we have to use a weapon?
Current, are we gonna deem it a piece of shit counter?
Currently, the guy is holding the swords, and Ian, before this, had not, like, checked out the sword at all. Like, you have to look at the sword, you have to try it out of it to, like, get a feel for, like, how much damage it does and what hit damage.
Remember when we fucking, remember when Dominic had his fucking vendor and, like, Dominic, and then we had the vendor, and the vendor was like, yep, here are my weapons, they're for this much gold, and then Dominic told us how much damage each fucking weapon did, so we weren't making bad, shitty financial decisions. There you go!
I mean, the way that works for this game would be, oh, he tells you, like, oh yes, this sword is very good, it's been like this, it's able to do this, this, and this, and that would equate to, like, its effectiveness in combat, like how much damage it does.
Okay, motherfucker. Can we get numbers or can't we?
You can if he asks. The guy in game.
How about this then? How about the sword Ina is actually holding right now? The fucking one he got from Nina.
Okay, that one he has used for a bit of time. So he can tell that.
Okay, so there is a system. Yes. All you had to say is there's a system, you have to use the sword to figure it out. That's
okay.
It.
Okay, the damage on it is 1d5. The hit, he gains no bonuses to hit.
Wait, okay, so never mind.
Then what does the guy say the swords are?
So you ask him, like, hey, what can that sword do? Like, what can it do? Well, this sword is blah 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 blah, which basically equates to plus one to hit and 2d3 worth of damage.
Also, isn't Ian, like, the weapons guy?
Yeah. He basically...
He is also the weapons guy?
He's basically...
He has no weapon.
He's proficient with every weapon, yes.
Why the fuck is he now?
I can't literally use anything as a weapon, because that's actually one of my skills.
Yeah.
Fuck the world.
You're completely negated right now, since you have weapons now. It makes nothing... It doesn't help you.
I could pick up a table, and I could use it as a sword if I wanted to.
Yeah,
I mean,
but
it wouldn't be counted.
The effectiveness of that table in battle, still pretty shit.
I mean, it would be counted as a hammer, not a sword. But yes,
use me.
Let's say we're in a bar fight. Fucking Dominic can also pick up another table and use it as a weapon. He'll just use it slightly less effectively. He can't even use it as effectively as you, thanks to his stats.
Nick.
Yeah.
If we count it as a hammer?
Yeah, a table?
Okay, listen, motherfucker. Games typically do, like, oh, hey, here's a weapon. And it's like, oh, if you can use whatever you want as a weapon, it's counted as this type of weapon. That's usually done because you can't fucking account for everything. There's literally zero purpose for having it categorized as a fucking hammer.
I mean, blunt force. It's a blunt object that you would throw at something. You throw hammers, and they are blunt force objects.
No, you don't.
I'm sorry, what?
Wait, what? So my character's a ranged character?
No, you don't throw your hammer, but you can throw a hammer.
He said you throw hammers. I have a hammer, therefore I throw it, I guess.
You throw hammers, not all.
Blunt type damage, known for its fucking range effectiveness.
Not all hammers are created equal.
God damn. Blunt force is what I'm trying to get at here.
Yeah, apparently only blunt force is hammers. And you have to throw them.
I mean, it's the most common type of blunt force.
Mace.
Blind hammer hammers. Time!
No fucking flails, maces, shields, fists.
We're just tearing apart Nick's.
Anyway, that is the stat on the guard sword.
Nice.
What do you do with that information? Do you want to sell them for 100 gold each? Or do you want to, like, take one and then sell the other as well as the current sword you're wielding? First off, you have to answer his question. So, may I ask how you procured these swords?
He already did. He already answered that.
I didn't hear him earlier because you guys cut him off. Say again.
Actually, we didn't.
No, we didn't, because we both heard it.
Oh, something about a river or something? I don't know.
I said I got them from a trader by the bridge for cheap.
What bridge?
That's exactly what the guy asks. What bridge? May I ask?
Shit. Shit. You don't know any names. You don't know any names. Didn't bother writing that shit down. You're fucked. Get hosed.
The bridge over here.
Here?
The bridge over here.
I do not see a bridge anywhere inside. Where might this bridge be?
Oh my god, Nick. Okay, talking in real life now, Nick, you are killing me right now.
No, actually, I agree with Nick on this one.
Like, the guy's gonna ask you, like, hey, these swords look really good, and these look like guard swords. Where the hell did this guy get them?
That's true. It looks, honestly, looks really good. He doesn't want to buy the swords from you. He doesn't want to sell you the swords. And he doesn't want to sell you the swords, and then, like, the guards come around, and they're like, man, where'd you get these swords? You know, we found a patrol missing, and the guy has to go through, like, all the legal shit. It's too much fucking work for this shit. He doesn't need to make money if it's gonna cost him too much stress. Yeah.
Or a limb, or a hanging.
Yeah, no, it could be infinitely, yeah, it could get infinitely worse. He could be fucking killed over this shit. Either way, fuck it. Either way, you're gonna need to maybe helpfully not kill him. Maybe he doesn't want to die. That's the bottom line. He wants to live.
Getting confused now. I said I got them from a trader from the bridge by the river.
Yes, but...
Alright, so what's this guy's hotness?
Will roll that now.
You said he was wimpy.
I know.
Doesn't fucking matter. Hotness. He already gave a physical description. Fucking gotta roll the hotness.
Yeah, he's like a 18.
Wow, he managed to kill lower.
No, not the android. Like, while he does look wimpy, he's not like so wimpy that he's just like, oh, little cute baby or little fat baby, whatever.
Wow. Okay. Wow.
I guess, yes, man, his hotness is 18. You can try seducing him to sell the weapons. That is a possibility.
You have one hotness over him. Don't do this.
I'm not gonna do that. But I already told him how I got them. I got them from a trader from
the bridge by the river. And he asked what bridge?
And then you never even answered that question.
I did. I said the one by the river.
And then he asked... I do not see a river nearby. What river?
He's now asking the name of the river.
Oh my god. Seriously?
Yes!
Most people don't... Most people in ancient times didn't name the rivers. Oh my god.
What the fuck, are you serious? Yes, they did!
When you have a river nearby, do you call it, the blah 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 river? You normally
ever heard of the Nile? Ever heard of the Tigris and Euphrates?
Hey, ever heard of the
Yellow
River?
Ever heard of the Gila River?
Those weren't fucking 2012, man. Those are like fucking who knows what BC.
Can everyone just shut up now? I cannot deal with this shit.
If you cannot this tell me the great. Name, please tell me what was nearby. Please.
There was a forest. It was over towards the west, I think.
It was towards the
west.
The forest? What?
There was a forest.
There? Whatever. Not my problem. Not my fault. There's a fucking forest. Dominic returned back to his forest? Who knows? That could have been his fucking forest.
Could have been.
I don't fucking know.
Okay.
Honestly, you see one tree, you've seen them all. They all kind of start blending together.
Yeah. Ian, you're gonna have to roll a persuasion check. It's gonna be a d20 plus 13. You're gonna need a 26.
At this point, you might want to just
fix the guy. Exactly.
Wow.
So, he looks at the sword for a solid, like, minute or so, looks back at you for a solid minute, he's like, okay, I'm willing to buy these swords off you. 100 gold each.
Okay, now I'm going to think to myself here for a moment. Do I want the... Actually, getting the... swapping my current sword for one of the castle swords might be a better idea, because... My current sword—it's a 1d5, so at max I can do 6 damage and do a minimum of 1 damage. And on the other hand, the castle sword can do a minimum of 2 damage since it's 2d3 and do a maximum of 6 damage.
Mm-hmm. Wait, how did your d5 sword go to 6 damage?
No. The castle
you
sword.
You said 6. No, he said 6.
He said it correctly.
No, he said 6.
No, he said 5 for the first one, and then...
I'm going to ask the smith to have a look at my current sword as well.
Oh, God, you already know what the current sword does. Why do we have to go through this?
He's wondering, like, gold value.
Yeah.
So, the smith takes the sword, and he's like, yes. This sword...
Pretty shit.
Yes, it's quite underwhelming. I would give you maybe... 20 gold for this?
Question. How much would it cost to reforge one of the higher quality swords with material from the lower quality sword? How much would that cost?
Well, you wouldn't actually get any gain from doing so.
What?
You see, the reason these swords cost so much more gold is that the material they are made with is... reinforced steel, which has been, you know, forged for tempered. Quite a long time. Yes, tempered. And so...
higher quality.
Yes, of a higher quality steel. So, using something of a lower quality to try and strengthen something of a higher quality, you would first off need an enormous amount, and then melt all of that down, and then combine it into one creation to be able to even boost it by even one point. And so...
Alright.
So you're telling him it's a useless idea.
Yes, it will not be fruitful for anyone involved. And it would cost something along the lines of 1,000 gold to be able to get all materials, smush them together, and then reinforce this for such little gain is so... blah.
Alright. What if you were to do it with both of the higher quality swords?
Into your lower quality sword, I would assume?
No, I meant... both the higher quality into one.
Into one sword.
Higher quality with the higher quality.
There's not enough material from the one sword to be able to put into another to actually make it
better.
Are they
still talking?
Yes.
They are. You might as well You might as well just go do something else, because technically you're not even supposed to know this is fucking happening. You might as well just straight up throw another game up. I'm currently building. Shit, so.
But yes, it would not be worth it to try and reforge this one sword with the other sword. Plus, it would also cost another 400 gold, at the least.
Alright, what about the lower quality with the higher quality?
Holy shit.
Again, also not worth it, because in the end, you would maybe get... the same amounts, and you would also have to pay more gold for actual reforging. So again, not very efficient. I at least wouldn't take that deal. I highly doubt anyone else would either.
Alright, I'll sell you the lower quality sword and one of the higher quality swords. That would be 120 gold, correct?
Yes, 120.
Pleasure doing business with you, good sir.
And you as well. Ian, you now have 120 gold and a new... Well, and you now... I'm assuming you now equip the old sword. Or the new sword.
Yeah.
Alright.
I now have a sword that has 2d3 of damage.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
God damn it.
Maybe you'll actually kill something.
So, what do you want to do now, if anything?
Back. Okay,
look at duck.
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'll look for Harmony, I guess.
Alright.
Aim for direction.
So, you know that she's gonna be at the fountain, so you meet up at the fountain. Does anyone else want to do anything, or shall we just go to the fountain?
I was going to the adventurer's hall. Fuck you.
Alright, so...
I learned where that shit is. I'm going there.
Alright, so...
Fuck everything else.
First off, you make it to the fountain square, and... When he said you couldn't miss this fountain, he was not joking. This fountain has water gushing 30 feet high in the air.
Want to fucking bet? Want to see me roll my perception?
Well, you're not there yet. Harmony is the first to arrive at it.
Great.
So cool. You see that this fountain is shooting water extremely high in the air and falling down all around. Like, it's almost like a water park. There are children running through the streets, getting wet and all. You can see a couple kissing there under the water as it falls down onto their heads as they get wet with each other.
Great.
And you can also see many people drinking the water straight out of the fountain as well. Oh, overall, this place is the haps, as they say.
Alright.
So,
great. To the adventurer's hall.
You see...
I go fuck about the fountain. Is there anything that catches my eye?
I'm
walking through it.
You do
anything notable or interesting? Or am I just gonna... Or is there fucking nothing?
I'm getting into that. You see a group of people dressed entirely in black, which seems very out of place, considering that most other people have some splash of color on them. For instance, you see some housewives or... That something like look like housewives with white aprons on, as well as like a red overshirt. So this group of black-looking individuals seems out of place, as well as what seems to be an old man. Most people here are fairly young-looking. Like at most, somebody's probably around 33. At the youngest, there's, like, a baby there. But there's an old man there as well. He looks like he's in his upper 90s, I would say. And he's dancing around in the rain. Well, not rain, the water. Like, oh, howdy doody, woohoo! I love the rain. Yeah!
Dancing in it?
Yeah, he's dancing in it. And he does say rain, by the way.
Oh, God. Alright, well, he seems interesting, but not interesting enough to dissuade me from going to the fucking,
Guildhall, yes. So,
Guildhall.
You find the directional thing, you find north, you find the Guildhall. The Guildhall looks like a fairly long building. Like, from the side, yep. You see that width-wise, it's not too big. It's about, like, 20 feet across. It's a decent size, but long-wise, it's very, very long. Like, you can't even see the end of the Guildhall from where you are standing. It just seems like it goes off into the horizon, never stopping. So you walk inside, and... It is a party, my bro. You can see that some people that were once wet are now drying off inside. Seems as though they came inside from, you know, being drenched by the fountain. You see many people drinking mead and yelling stories of adventure and sorrow and whatnot. You see many a group. You see miners. You see butchers. You see warriors. You see... The housewives, you see every type and sort that you could imagine. All here.
Except for the black suit guys, right? They're not here?
There is actually a group of black people in the corner.
Like, the same ones that were outside?
They look similar, but you can tell that...
No.
These guys actually are bald. The other guys outside had hair, these guys are bald.
But they're exactly the same, like, outfit.
Yes, outfit-wise, they are exactly the same.
Great.
You see dwarves, you see elves. You even see...
Tumble.
A centaur. who everybody is crowding around like, ooh, a centaur. How exciting.
Great. That's cool. Everything looks cool and all. Let's look for the... Where are the quests at? Let's go find... See if I can find out.
The guild hall is quite crowded, and... What? You walk around for a solid 10 minutes not knowing where anything is.
Yep.
Unable to find it.
Great. That's fine. Great. Great, great. Alright, see if I can find someone who's not fucking drunk out of their mind.
Okay, so you walk around for another 5 minutes or so, and you find a group of ladies off in the corner. Well, not corner, off to the
side.
Off to the side. They look like they have just gotten in and are about to begin drinking, but have not actually started yet.
Okay, great.
It's a group of five of them sitting around a table.
This is a riveting fucking D&D game. Let's go. What if we all just talked and talked to NPCs? Over and over again. Alright. So I'm gonna go up and start asking them questions. Hey! Hello! Hi! Hi. I just wanna know some things about this place. You know, if I could, where I could find a quest, the quests? Are there dispense quests?
They all look at you with a sort of, like, look of disdain, I would say.
Oh, great. Fuck you guys.
They're sort of, like, dagger eyes, like, saying sort of, like, who the hell is this person? Who the hell does this person think they are? Coming up to us?
Wow. Okay.
But one of them does respond with a... sort of a gentler face than the rest of them. If you walk around that way, and she points in the direction that you need to go, you'll find the main, patron of the hall. They'll be able to give you quests and whatnot, as you so asked.
Oh, okay, thank you. Walk away.
Alright. You notice as you're walking away, like, the other four girls that were at the table, like, kind of look at this girl with disdain as well, like, why'd you talk to her? Get the fuck out.
Alright. Great.
So, you walk up for another 5 minutes, and you're able to find the, like, main bulk of the guild hall, like, this person that is, like... Welcome. What may I help you with today?
Well, I wanted to look at the quests you have.
Ah, yes. This is this is a female with...
Drolling it.
33 hotness. She's pretty...
Great.
She's pretty good looking. She's like, yes, I can help you with many of that sort, yes.
Yeah, I just want to look for side quests, please.
Alright. Anything in particular that you may want?
Let's avoid... I'd like to avoid killing and or harming, like, anyone or anything.
She kind of winces and says, that is the majority of our quests here. But I'm sure we can find something that will suit your interests. So she pulls out this kind of massive book and, like, slams it on the desk and starts flip through it. And these pages, at the beginning, these pages look extremely old, like, super dusty, looking like that if you, like, pull them a little too hard, they just, like, fall to pieces. But she goes through all the pages with a sort of brevity that you really can't see anywhere else. Very quickly.
Great.
And neatly. Eventually, she stops at a page, which seems to be fairly new in comparison to yeah. the other ones shown. Ah, yes, here we go. Would you be interested in a stakeout?
Maybe. Let's keep looking.
Okay. She starts flipping through again, and she eventually finds another quest. There is a quest to help an herbalist with his procurement of, well, herbs. It would involve going into a forest and potentially harming animals, or at least scaring them off.
You know, so let me get the info for that quest, and we'll keep looking.
Alright. She starts flipping through again, and she eventually finds... This time it takes her a long while, like a solid 4 minutes of just flipping through.
Wow, so long. 4 minutes? Holy shit.
So, I now have the information for the herbalist side quest, right?
Yes.
That quest? Mm-hmm. Okay. Just checking.
I mean, you gotta remember that she's flipping through these pages, like, at an amazing speed, like, probably one page per second.
Alright, so, moving along. Mm-hmm. 4 minutes pass. She finds another thing.
I have one to settle an argument between a husband and wife.
Oh. Yeah, I could probably do that. Let me get that information. Okay, I'm sorry for taking a point. Is there any possibility I could, like, leave a quest?
The way our quest system works is that once you complete a quest, the quest giver will should give you a slip of some sort. And once you are given the slip, you then turn that back into here, and we give you the gold for said quest, or whatever reward was tied with the quest. Okay. Depending on how well you do in the quest giver can give you a tip as well, though that's typically frowned upon.
Dodging my question. I want to know if I can leave a quest.
Yes, you may leave a quest at any time, considering that...
How would I... Okay.
Considering that the only way you actually complete the quest is if you get that slip and turn it into us, then are not held to any quest at any time. You can leave a quest or rejoin a quest at any time.
Okay, I just want to know, so how would I go about the process of leaving a quest?
You just stop interacting, I suppose. I suppose technically you never leave a quest. It's more of you never aspire to finish the quest. As I said, you can leave...
You're not understanding what I'm saying. I want to... Nick, I want to fucking leave a quest here for other adventurers to maybe finish.
Oh...
I don't want not drop the quest as in I don't want to fucking do it anymore. Okay. As I want to drop a quest as in I want somebody to do this shit for me because fucking Harmony's too busy to do it. Okay. To actually go do things.
Yes, you just talk to me. What quest and at what price would you like to set?
Let's see. Well, I'm just looking for a person.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just looking for a person.
Do you happen to have a picture or description of them?
I do have a description, and I'm gonna spit that description.
I feel like we're in hell. This is like their elevator music.
We are in basically literal hell. This is like super fucking... annoying. This is what happens.
Well, it's only the music that's getting to me.
It's only the what?
Music.
Oh, I can change.
Been
listening
to Wind Waker for like 2 hours.
All right, fine. Let's go for. Hang on.
I've been listening to my own music on YouTube this whole time.
I've been dying.
Chris and Iggy.
Go with there. All right.
Sure, whatever.
Why not? So yes, you talk with the person for a while. Well, you give her the description of the person, and she's like, "How much gold are you willing to put up for this?"
Let's see, I got like fucking nothing. How much gold was for each quest? Like, how much gold was like the was each of the quests I got? The settle domestic dispute and herbalist quest.
The herbalist quest was 30 gold. The settle domestic dispute was 10 gold. The what was the other one? Sorry.
Stakeout.
The stakeout one was 50 gold.
Oh wow. Okay. So these are all. But then again, none of these are actually killing anything. So there's not a whole, probably not a whole lot of profit in these. All right. Well, we'll go with, let's see, 30, 10, and then 50, that gives me up to 90. Currently I have, like, 50 sticking around. Yeah, 100 gold.
Alright.
Sure.
100
gold.
Okay, do you, you don't have 100 gold to give her, though.
Wait, what?
So, the way the slip system works is that once you,
So, wait, I need to actually give her the reward.
Yeah, you pay up front.
So, wait, and then I can... I pay up front, okay.
And then if you ever want to retract it, you just go in, take the gold, and be like, hey, we're through.
Okay, alright. Oh, okay. Okay, so... Well, I can only currently only offer 10 gold, so 10. 10 gold left to do for now.
All right, 10 gold.
10 gold to find the person.
Sounds
find the person. Good. Give the script. 10 gold to find the person. Give the description. Hooray.
Yay, you did it.
I've left a quest.
I was like 10 minutes into that. I left, fucking got a bowl of coffee and ice cream, ate it, and even put the bowl back, and it still wasn't done.
Uh-huh.
Oh, fuck.
I mean...
Yeah?
Alright, so... Yes. Okay. Alright, so leave that quest there. It's 10 gold. Maybe I'll come back and put more gold for the reward to see if maybe somebody will actually do it. But, alright, time to actually look at the information. Trying to let's look at the information for the side quests.
Yeah. Alright, so...
Alright. Domestic dispute. Let's go.
Okay, that is... You find that this quest has been issued at about a month ago, you would say.
Wow.
And, this
okay.
is between husband and wife. Husband's name is Cal. The wife's name is Kalan. And their dispute is about whose name should be used for the marriage certificate. Cal or Kalan?
Cal or Kalan? Can I get a spelling?
C-A-L for Cal and then C-A-L-I-N for Kalan.
C-A-L for Cal and C-A... What?
C-A-L-I-N. Kalan.
L-I-N?
Mm-hmm. Kalan.
Like that.
Yes, Kalan.
Go ahead and keep pronouncing it that way. Okay.
I will.
Alright, so... Alright, let's... Well, go ahead, time to go do this.
Alright.
I don't have anything else. Does that mean I'm supposed to be at the fountain? Fuck the fountain.
So...
I have no reason to be there.
Iggy, anything you want to do?
Yeah. Kind of wanted to find, like, a weapon place.
Alright. You walk around for a bit.
Oh, good! Riveting, riveting!
Listen, motherfucker, you spend like half an hour doing your shit.
You walk around for a bit, find a smith. This is the same smith that Arm went to earlier, so yes, you're there.
Cool. I'm gonna just go up to the dude. Fuck his hotness. Not right. Literally.
Aw, you sure?
I'm gonna draw a few symbols.
Alright.
That's it. I don't think there's anything else.
He stares at you for a solid minute or so, and once you finish drawing, he's like, I don't think I can help you with that bear. I'm sorry. But I do not create those sorts of weapons at this shop. If you're looking for swords, lances, harpoons even, I got them. But whatever, like, throwables are not my sort of thing.
He doesn't create hammers then.
Yeah, no hammers.
You could ask for throwing knives.
Okay. Fucking scared me for a second. Jesus. Can you guys still hear me? Hello? Hello? Can you hear me?